Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is a part three. Part three of four, Ratež Novo mesto, political massacre in independent Slovenia after 1995. In case you have not seen this here, I do recommend you so. But for the investigators, a must is this here. When I recorded this on January 8, 2021, it came to me during, just after I finished the whole thing off. I have also written below a brother of the gentleman, therefore the person you hear in the audio recording is about 5 years older than his brother. At least three. I remember there was like a significant 5 years. I still bet for 5 years. Difference between the two. One was like, yeah, 5 years definitely, yes. One was still a baby, 14 years old. The other one already was 18 to 19, something like this. Adult man, 20. At least, I would say five at least. At least five, I'm gonna say, if not more. Not three, but at least five, if not more. And he is also of a lighter complexion than the gentleman I have spoken with. Kind of, you will not figure out that we are brothers. Very, very important for me to know that this stuff, because he was involved in this stuff earlier than his younger brother. This is a younger brother. Okay? Absolutely, this is going to be one of the credits you're going to give me immediately. It's something I did fail to mention. Then another credit you're going to give me is education. He is not a car mechanic. He is exactly the opposite of his brother. He is, I don't know, but it's some kind of degree, involved some kind of degree, is educated, like with degree educated. He's got some kind of, I don't know whether he was in IT or he was in some kind of engineering, something like that. So the two are a big, big contrast, okay? So you got that? His brother is definitely identified. Both are identified. Now, in the part three, what I'm going to do is I'm going to claim credits for, of course, the gentleman who met me. I have already the stuffs in the sleeve that I'm not going to state in this video in case somebody would be suspicious about something. I do have, I always reserve certain things that I can use and immediately go back in time and point out certain things, so that nobody can possibly refute me. You see, I disclose portion of it, but another portion that I know, in case there will be a person that would say, "Oh, but we don't know each other," I still keep it here inside in my sleeve. The gentleman I am talking to identified, absolutely identified, two people. That's again husband and wife. Both murdered, gunned down by the neighbor, identified. The neighbor identified. Daughter of a couple I have just stated, identified. A person who purchased the home afterwards from these people, identified. Then there is going to be a truck company, trucking company. We're going to call this identified, but I'm not going to tell you anything about it. But I know how, piece by piece, the whole thing and when the whole thing was assembled. And it's a very difficult one. There is a restaurant. It's called Mrak. This is a piece of cake. This is too easy. Identified, but I'm not going to even claim credit. I will get to that in a little bit. And then there is a neighbor of the trucker, of this trucking company, a mechanic, who owns the business, also is identified. And I am not going to say anything about it. Like I said, some of the stuff is going to stay in here. Now, other stuff, I am just going to go about it. So, what I will do for the investigators, I am just going to provide you with factual proofs, which are going to be more than good enough for what I stated. These are all the credits you're going to give me. You're just going to go with the check marks and just give me. Now, if you have additional questions, you want to go somewhere with me, talk about this for more. Sure, this is not easy. We can sit in the car and we can go and from dot to dot, and we can do a whole lot more. That's all there is. Let's go to the business. This is continuation of what you see here foremost. These are physical proofs and how this stuff came to life, or why this stuff was even postponed. Everything is explained in this part here, one of four. I wanted to mention to you also something really, really meaningful to me. I don't know if this is going to take too long. I still have problems like this. They have done something to my either operating system, or they might have done this. By the way, you have seen how the internet works, right? Either I believe they did this to my operating system, or they must have done it to the modem itself through the computer or something like this. I have no idea. I don't have a time for stuff like that, but it's really nothing that really works. Whatever I get is not working, and so on and so forth. There's just a lot of troubles everywhere. But that's okay, because they're trying to purchase time. I understand that you should do. Look, you hear this song?
He even called me brilliant.
He's respected in his country.
Both of these individuals are very dangerous schizophrenics, for one thing, and violent. Very dangerous. First of all, what we're going to do is we're going to put time and date when this stuff is presented to you. The tape today is, like I stated, January 10, 2021. The tape I'm about to play to you was assembled together on December the 3rd of 2020. And this will be precisely this one here. The tape is edited. It is much shorter, December the 10th, January the 3rd of 2021. I don't know what got in my head. No, the 3rd, January, not the December. January the 3rd, 2021. The tape I have played to you just right now, I am sure you have guessed. That's why I said both are really dangerous schizophrenics. Really dangerous. This individual, and I want you to see me when I state this to you. During MKUltra torture, the problem was he was not alone. He stated this right next to Angela Merkel and other people whom he was involved with, laughing. They were laughing. They had a really good time. They played this music. If something I can come up with, I was asked with kind of song I would like and this and that, awkward stuff. First they did this, then they asked me. They somehow alluded to this song. I don't know how they did. And this is the song I stated, and that's basically where Vladimir portrayed himself with all the elegance. This is a mentally retarded schizophrenic individual. This is undoubtedly not a sane individual. He's not 100% in his head. He finds the thrill I never did. He did. In drugging up 100%, raping women, killing people and stuff like this. This is the thrill he finds. You see, he doesn't do it, like a song itself says, he doesn't do it because it would be necessary, something like this. He does it for the thrill. He does it foremost for the money, but this is going to be disclosed, everything about him and his friends who made this happen time and again in the part 4 of this series, 404, about Ratež, about this vicinity only, all right? You're also going to accredit me. There is another man, about another man. It's called Papish, Sandy Papish. And also you're going to accredit me about his son. So these are two more you're going to accredit me, right? That's how we're going to do that kind of stuff. So there is, if you have a check mark, you can just go jig, 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 jig. You can just write down the stuff I stated. Now let me explain to you how you're going to do this for me. I should say, let's go to the business. The location where I met this individual was again about 50 meters away from this car as I was coming to the car. So the gentleman is basically from the same location as the other gentleman was. We are just talking, we continue to talk about this location here at Ratež. This location here, and this location is close by here to Novo Mesto. You see, it's really close by. I am from here, and in this case, the road is going to involve interesting route. Yeah, and I did pinpoint it out to you once, so you can see it. This is a castle with torches right here. And pretty much this is where it all happened. And we would go like this. We would continue this way, he and I. And basically we would stop here, but the Google Maps won't allow me to zoom into this thing here, you know. Here's the VAC store. I'm not gonna say anything about it, but again, I can tell enough for me to claim credit about it, you understand? This is Znash Transport, DOOP Gumberg, okay? Let's just put it this way, all right? When this gentleman started with a business, and he started with a business, I estimate, sometimes in about 97, I would say. About 5 years later, so, this store also popped up, his neighbor also. This is all through, it looks like one property almost here. It's not. This is a separate individual box store, a separate person. This here, however, this is where it all started, a mechanic shop, and so on and so forth. He's got another location, and this location is in so-called Terska Gora. This location here. So now, I just happen to know, if somebody needs, and I'm going to take time and go here and smell this a little bit back and forth, and I'm going to tell you basically step by step basically everything, what exactly was purchased first, where, how it all started, and so on and so forth. You understand? Including with the Terska Gora, the whole thing, because it's a really, really, I remember, difficult concept. Unless you would know one, you would not be able to tell this stuff. I am not going to go into and do stuff without which, because, yeah, why would I do this if I can go out there and eventually get physical proofs for it, right? It's not paying me off to give the feedback like this, or rather use this to do when I need to do this kind of stuff, right? So that I can get something out of it. Then it's going to be about this here, this location here. This is a restaurant. This is a restaurant, Mrak. It's an old, old, old restaurant, but this here, this tool was rearranged, but this is too damn easy to go about this kind of stuff. I mean, this is just too easy. Believe me, really easy for me. I am not gonna go into any of it. I'm waiting for somebody to say that I don't know about these things, okay? And what I will be talking to you finally is the house behind this thing here. This is the house of the Pochette. This is the family house, which basically, and I remember the words clearly, where it all happened, how it came all to argument, how the argument broke out and this and that. And then you have here, you have Medle. Medle is my schoolmate here. Medle. You see Medle, Kmetia Medle. That's my schoolmate. He also was involved in MKUltra. You go also this way down. I remember about that kind of stuff too. It's pretty much all these people that were involved with it. Now, many of them were really, really scared, but this couple hosted me inside of the house, the mom and dad. They would bring me to their house. What's going on with this house? With the house, it's like this. These were one of the first people involved in MKUltra. One of the first. The couple basically decided that they're gonna help me, it doesn't matter how, and this and that. And then was this cretin, who I believe, and I'm not completely certain, because Donald Trump loved to visit this place here, this was his location here, this mrak. And whatever this cretin was, it was always a lot of misinformation. It was always a problem with information. But I think that the neighbor I'm talking about most likely was from here, from this household here somewhere. Eventually not from this one, and even less, it kind of a funny is, but appeared to me that would be from here. This area here changed. I would have to pay some attention, and then I would tell you about more about this area here too. All this was an MKUltra area, folks. But from the United States of America between 95 to mid-2006, from Miami, Florida, from Miami Beach, Florida, to witness all kinds of stuff. The argument broke out right here. It's always the shit that happened whenever people were around me that they exploded with emotions. Why did the argument broke out? I have no idea. I remember only claimed that they are not going to help. They are not going to help. Stated something to someone that it was more people, and he argued he was like completely mad. Because he was neighbor sometime, he would even come with a tool. That's a funny stuff. All through, whenever they would not want him to be around, still somehow they met. Oh, this is interesting one. That he will not allow, and I don't know what, that he will do whatever it takes, there will not be. Now, if we go back here to this place here, the year sometimes, boy, this was one of the first things, the most horrific things that happened. Stuff that actually totally shattered the entire area. I would almost have an impression as if the guy was some kind of agent for almost, I would say, for this old system, for this Urbo or something like this. Because this guy was like some kind of, he had like fanatical views or something like that. I have no idea, but the year, I believe, was like as early as 97, 98. The two of them, who would always have me along them, finished, 97 probably even, finished this house. They worked their ass to finish this house, and they told me, finally, we finished the house, and now what's going to happen is we're going to kick off. Probably it was like 98. They were around here. And this was the house they fixed, and they moved in. Inside the house was like a lot of wood, I think. It was like a lot of wood inside, all right? just for me to give you an idea, the route that I took you through here, this one here, so just that we straighten these things to make them straight. The route that I took you, this route here, this from Otochets, this route here, this route must have been probably, in 95 I left Slovenia. That means now is 2021, and that means about 26 years I would not ever commute through here. You understand? Supposedly for 26 years, I never ever was a single time going past this store here. But I was, because the people would bring me from this place, from Ratež, they would keep and they would revive the memories. Even when I was inside of the mental hospital, when I were elsewhere, they would keep bringing me back on a picture. That was the name of the song, whatever agreement they had. With the politicians, and these people would not let go just easily. And as far as this thing here, the gentleman you're gonna hear on the audio recording is we pass through here. You know, we go, that's a mistake what I stated right now. That's a total mistake. Yeah, that's a total mistake. I think he actually tells me that the couple actually is from here somewhere. He says from here, that they are from here. You're going to hear this on the audio recording. No, there is nothing here. This what happened is nowhere here. This is where he and I would walk that day. So that's a good stuff too. That's a really good stuff. It's nowhere here. They're not here. The couple is exactly from where I demonstrated you. This place here. This is this here. Okay? Because I remember this here too. This store here. This store. Varnost MBD. Trgovina DOO. This was an individual who purchased. The daughter would sell the house and she would leave to Miami, United States of America. You're going to hear me saying, oh, well, it's actually St. Petersburg, right? I say, no, it's not St. Petersburg. It was actually North Miami. And because of the stuff I have seen in the U.S. where I was, no. This was not a way to treat human being in any way. I was actually treated worse than a slave. Excuse me, this was worse than a slave. You still don't know nothing in respect to this stuff about what went on. This was my vicinity of where I used to live. Sorry about that. Here. Right here, this was my vicinity, eventually apartment building, which balconies was actually used, if not the doors, if they couldn't get through the door, they would use the balcony to actually get through the door inside of my unit. You see, it's a shared balcony. I heard that after I left, they have even posted something in between and those balconies, so that people could not trespass in that sense or whatever, but that was not the case when I was there. Okay? This is how I will all demonstrate about how they hijacked me from the bed in Miami. All that stuff, all that good stuff is coming. Yes, indeed. And so what the girl did, She didn't move to the Fort Myers, Tampa, as I anticipated. And yes, I did state it also, I still state, all through it's reduced. It is on the original tape, and I included in the end, you hear me, that she actually moved to Miami. She did, and I know so, the gentleman doesn't tell me, nobody tells me, but I guarantee you, this is just the way it is, this is just the fact. She moved to, in my opinion, North Miami, must be something here, something in this area, I think, North Miami, something like this. It was not a beach house, beach property or something like this. It was like North Miami, something like that in that sense, property. What exactly happened is that when this accident, when this horrific shit happened, she was completely brain shattered. It was a terror. It was a terror that happened. Now, the individual, I think he was from here, from this household here. Not this one, but this one here. It was a terror that it shuddered, screamed for people to submit into a terror. That's why I stated what I stated. I mean, these are two beautiful, beautiful people, husband and wife, just minded their own business, friendly. I remember they would bring me here. I was always welcome here, you know. They would be always like, young people, you know, just like, come on in, you know, this and that. Like super nice, super friendly people. I don't even know how to explain. So they got murdered like this, and I wonder about the whole thing still. This was definitely a political kill. It was something political they had to do. And the girl who just about, I think, finished education, and I am not completely sure, was it she went forward to finish to get like 4-year degree, and after she got that 4-year degree, she put everything on sale, so that means it was about 25 years old, sold everything. I understand even the people here somehow came up with idea to send her to me. I was too fucked up in my head to realize the tragedy of all this shit. And I was unwilling to accept the responsibility of any kind for absolutely anything at that point in time. I did not feel, basically girl from my city, our people, everything, that I owe absolutely anyone anything at all. Now, for the people that this should have happened to this community here, all around, for this city, Novo Mesto, this was like a really, really bad, bad gesture, and it was resentment. When did this thing happen? Probably that she left to Miami, USA. I estimate probably about in year 2002 she had it. And you understand, I was in Miami Beach until mid-2006. It was 2001, 2002, something like this. She was so angry, she was so disappointed, she was so hurt that she said she never want to know about Slovenia again. This is how hurt she was. She said that she wants to leave like me, that she doesn't want to know about anymore anything, that it was too much, this was for her too much. The trauma was overwhelming. This man, you're gonna hear me talk to, this was one of the main initiator, wanted to help at all costs, but he was really, really cautious. Everybody, when that happened, the entire community. That must have happened actually in 97, because the idea was, the politicians had idea to brain kill people in Slovenia through that terror. It was, the idea was to create something so horrific so that the minds of the people would shut off. So that must have been really in 2001, something like that. 2002, 2001, probably the girl came to Miami. Probably she was about, I don't know, 24 years old. So just as I have completely explained to you totally, she went to the university, I think, to Ljubljana. Once she completed that stuff, she packed, she was gone. She couldn't handle it no more. Many people turned away from me because of the stuff, because I wouldn't want to marry with her, this and that. She was in MK Ultra, this and that. I would not want. The bottom line is, I didn't even know if I'm going to stay in the U.S. And the bottom line is that I went through so much stuff that under no way I would go and, you know, assume responsibilities of any kind. Okay, so this is why, ladies and gentlemen, the stuff here is titled as 3 of 4 Ratež Novo mesto political massacre in independent Slovenia after 1995. Since I finished my education in Slovenia, I would basically no longer pay visits to this location here. In 2006, out of respect, but I didn't feel I was too damn welcome. And I can completely understand that. I paid a visit. Still, to my teacher, to the man who sacrificed a lot to help me get through the school. He helped me with the math, he helped me with the physics, and this was this man here. You can see everything about that. I will make a special video about him. I'm not done doing video. But the pain. In respect to loss of the father was so severe, it was so painful. The pain was so bad that in 2006 when I was here, I felt that I shouldn't be coming here no more. Oh, 3 years later, he died. It was just, I didn't feel right coming there no more. His son had a really difficulty. Yeah, I felt it's better for me not to be there no more, come no more. And this guy, this was like, I would say, well, almost like my father. This guy would, he did earn the money, but he would live, it was more to him than just a job. He would sacrifice to come to help me out. And so I'm not done with this anywhere near yet. He was resented by Vladimir Putin, by his schizophrenic, paranoid agents, straight, I can tell you, murdered on a most primitive, most disgusting way. Came as a guest in the house, left poisoned, basically ended up spitting his guts through the cancer. This is why I no longer would come here to this place. I was hurt myself about all this. Although I have to tell you that in my mind was shuttered off, for you to understand why I haven't come to this earlier. Not only because of this stuff, they threatened me, they're gonna put me inside of the mental hospital, because this was all the time the stuff, the threat. It was a terror and threat, beatings and a threat, that as soon as I'm gonna start talking about this, it's gonna be schizophrenia, paranoia, and mental hospital. And that's exactly what happened after I started to talk. That's how they operated. This is the way they operated, right? So I thought that if I ignore this stuff, it's eventually gonna die away, go away somehow. But these people lasted, and their situation even improved. Definitely Vladimir Putin became wealthier and wealthier and wealthier. And I am gonna come to explain to you in the last part in four, who gave him this, his wealth, I should say. Who was the one who brought this debt back to Novo Mesto, to Slovenia, to the city of Novo Mesto, Slovenia? Why did this debt came here? Why more people had to die? In a part 404, I will explain absolutely everything. I'm not gonna hold anything back, even that it was all kinds of gimmicks. It was all kinds of gimmicks that were involved in it, you know? It was all kinds of warnings. And I will talk about all that stuff, what they did, who did. Prince Andrew, I'm gonna say, right here in Britain that you see, right here in Scotland, for which he deemed your women were far more beautiful than down in England. He disliked English women. That's why it was the Scotland, always. The Scotland, Edinburgh. Keswick was a very, very popular place. Got sighted twice. Twice did Scotland Yard from London. Twice Scotland Yard from London. From United Kingdom. Meddled basically with the police, with a police inspector from Keswick who investigated prostitution activities in the city. Bordellos at the time, bordels, they were not allowed. I can also tell you that in 95, in 96, in 97, the bordels were not allowed. But Prince Andrew, who would, with a kayak, commute himself to some location, to some other location from where, and that was on the other side of the lake from what I remember. They would pick him up, load him in the car, take him to the city, and that's, city was abounding with the beautiful Scottish ladies, had a lot of fun. Twice did Scotland Yard had to intervene, meddle into affairs of Keswick police station, so the truth would not come about. The royal, who would just casually, daily, basically go about fucking young women. It wasn't only in the US. The teenagers were also right here in Britain. He finally got caught in the US. You understand? This is the kind of stuff we will be talking about. We're gonna be talking about who brought Vladimir Putin back here to Slovenia, so more people could be murdered. And I did explain that already on my blog, everything about Belgrade in 1995, actually how Donald Trump transferred me, why they transported me to Belgrade, who was in Belgrade. I did explain about the Chetniks, about the Vojislav Šešelj and stuff like that. I didn't explain to you about young Vučić, who was actually the first that somehow got a hold of me, and then he would take me to his vujek, to his uncle, in Belgrade in this apartment. There was like big apartment complex, a lot of apartments, and it's something I'm gonna go research, probably even find his apartment, wherever he was, point you out, explain you everything, and probably point you out even where the lady that would do more than just the house cleaning used to, what house she came from and stuff like that. From 95 all the way to 2001, this is what the situation was. That's when finally American Democrats find out about what really went on, because Americans alone would travel to Belgrade. They would bring me there. They would bring me over there. And they find out about it somehow from whoever. And it came out that this no longer was allowed. And that's where everybody became politically correct, including Boris Powell. That's when things started to change. Already before that, he started to change understanding what the whole thing was all about. Slovenian President Boris Powell was convincing Slovenian partisans that is in their best interest, regardless, to support even the Chetnik movement financially and so on. So the Slovenian money, the taxpayers' money, was flowing right here, literally for the sake of another war. And also right here, this is Russia. This Slovenia, a country too small to govern its own affairs, that's what they say to us, but big enough to support big wars against big nations. Interesting country, I'll tell you that. Let's go to the audio recording, and as I go along, you're gonna get the whole idea about, well, again, this was recorded on January the 3rd, 2021.
Dobar dan. Mam neki skorn što mam.
This year. Was anticipated by the British, I don't like to say British, the Battenbergers with Windsor's are not even really British. They don't like British, they don't like English, they like Scottish for one thing, and they are considering themselves as a Germans for one thing. This is how it is. I'm gonna put it this way. Look, Vladimir Putin anticipated he's going to benefit, because the truth is going to come out. And the Buckingham Palace threatened me that if I would release this stuff, that they're going to press the U.S. Congress, and the U.S. Congress is going to give the whole power to Donald Trump, that this is how they're going to get, and this and that. Much of the stuff I have actually even seen, because if you look at in a Congress, the numbers almost 50-50, almost. And what Donald Trump did is completely unheard of. If he's not going to get at least impeached, he should have been already arrested by now, but if he's not going to get impeached, then I don't know. Then the whole thing is like already really lost. This is how things are. They eventually insisted to me, right here, at this place here, in Scotia, they insisted to Canadians that eventually what's going to screw me up is that I'm going to come out with the truth about Vladimir Putin, about the whole truth about how Vladimir Putin became Vladimir Putin, who made him, and this and that. And because of this, they're not going to have a choice other than to go and collaborate with Donald Trump and dra 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 dra. That was the kind of stuff we are talking about. I will explain all this in part four. Don't worry about it. Let's go to the video and we'll translate audio for you. Just keep the pen handy. In addition to everything I have stated to you, just continue to checkmark the stuff I mentioned to you to give me credit. Let's go.
Dobar dan. Mam neki, neki skoro mam.
Hello, 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 hello. The gentleman and I start the conversation about the shoes. This was, according to MK Ultra, exactly the right subject. I am not going to even say exactly why that would be, but already when it comes to shoes, that's already something, let's say, I'm going to leave in my sleeve if I need for the future reference.
Dobar dan.
He says you don't have the boots, no? Because I'm using like camouflage shoes, like this kind of mountain hiking type of shoes. And I said, no, they're good, they're not bad. There's like a hiking shoes I purchased, really, really cheap, but with some extra insoles inside, are as good as the most expensive shoes, I think, especially because I don't clean them every day, because when you walk all over the mud, we had rain for 2 weeks. It doesn't make sense to clean them every day, and they do keep water out good enough for me to use them regularly. So he sees me with these muddy shoes going all over the mud. He's got also shoes like I have. But this is supposed to be our hello.
Dobar dan.
No boots in you. I do. It's not so bad.
Yeah,
but since we almost fell down and fell inside on the side. Said, but I got lucky and I catch myself. This is, do you have a phone with you?
My mommy говорит, telephone.
Yeah.
To me go for stopper.
They could
grab chip and I always tell my mom, keep the telephone with you in case she falls down somewhere. You know, and he says, well, they know where I work, so they would go and find me. And we talk about the car. It's not too far. You were able to hear in the part two. The car, we're still there. This is a really good friend of the gentleman you heard me talking to the other day.
Máte telefon, sábo?
Nemo.
Já zkus mojí mámi govorím, telefon, sábo.
Já.
To mi Google postává, protože... Vejo
podkrým, či mě naudomu dám všichni.
Telefon.
Ne, to nekori auto, kurva, kako se to prilekli u fosta. Okulio barin čekulie sama gvar.
I tell him that the car, he says he doesn't know how the car came to the forest and this, it still got the wheels on, he says, and this and that. I thought this is the car from your neighbor over there, from that Ratež.
What was this issue some propeller, wish?
But yes, the police.
The
Ratež up there, huh? Yes, I'm off to the Fion.
The gentleman explains he is from Ratež. I present myself, of course, to him and tell him about the car.
Yeah,
Marcus is here.
Then the Marga Fountain, the Hanukkah.
pa ne bo držal, on je mlad, ali 20 let star.
20 let pa yeah. Mehanik.
Je. Yeah.
No sen od znasa.
On je imel, nekdo mu je pomagal, ko je mama pa oče, ko so baba umrla. Mu je tale iz novega mesta, pa nisem pričal, da je to celo en policist, da mu je pomagal. Mislim, da je bil policist, pa nisem pričal. Je bil pa en tak gospod, starejši, tukaj ste vi v takih letih.
There is another credit you're going to give me about the police officer I have stated to you. Yes, in the part number two, that general was actually a detective. There were two detectives involved in this. Yeah, one detective became detective. He was a police officer. He was in the force, in the police force about... He probably served another, I don't even know, maybe 5-6 years. From 95 to 2000, 2001 something, then he became detective. He was promoted to become a detective. But then there was another individual, and this is the one I'm talking about. That individual always was a detective. That was the oldest detective, a police officer. That's the man I am talking about, to be completely precise about it.
In moj dugo stanovanje tele na Majde Širca na Ragovski.
This is the stuff I already have explained everything in a part 2.
Nekaj sem bil v njegovom stanovanju. Ne vem, ti je bil...
I was a little bit surprised right now because he mentioned me someone else.
Hodil bi se mi iz Rateža skozi do novega mesta, gor pa dol. Pa delati že začel, tako kot tisti zavalnici tam pri Merkuriju.
Ja?
Ja. Vi bi verili tega tema?
Would you know anything about or ask him for this young man?
Eden je veliko v zaporih tu je en...
V zaporih?
Prav te si pisal, starša moj pa eden tudi z naše vasi ustrelil in počne sebe.
Okay, so here's what it is. Polšet, this was yet another gentleman. The same thing. What we're gonna do is like this. It was too many dead people. That one was where we walked toward this location, toward his location. And he also demonstrated to me his home. Now, that's yet another story. Individual I'm talking about is Tramte. So, the sister left to US, to Miami, to North Miami she moved. Her brother, I understand, goes from prison to prison. A political system that would do the stuff like this? Slovenia? I think so. I would definitely say so. Lost both parents. It was one of our people from a village that would go and gun both down. Already explained at the beginning of the video, and then he also killed himself. This man, the man who gunned down both of them, was a Udba man. This was a man who, well, it just happened so that he actually was in some kind of service down in Serbia for I don't know how long. We have a clearly link. A political Udba link executing basically people, probably according to orders from the top here in Slovenia. Not probably, but 100%. I mean, I was sure that I was that only element that would horrify people, but I appeared first, but then also executions fortified this whole thing to astronomic. Amount.
Sem umor od njega. Obtožijo so ga neki stvari in bilo tako težko.
So yes, this is a different individual again, but again from the same Ratež, from the same village Ratež. So
mama je pa
today it's going to be about the Tramte family, about other people again, therefore
mama je pa bolehala.
In part 2 I have explained how the gentleman I have spoken with, his mom and dad committed, actually, father committed suicide and mom died from cancer.
Ta je več zaprt, ta fant, ko je starše in pol še postrelil.
So you can see now that the third person, the son, spends basically his life most of the time in the jail, right? So they gunned down both parents, and a son, his life is more time in the jail than outside of the jail. With the Slovenian people, this is how it is. A daughter ran out of Slovenia to the US, basically. Horror.
Nekaj sta handlala, pa je ta tramte, kukar on ga nekaj okul prinesel, in sto isto pištolo, ko mu je on jo...
I would not want to brag about this stuff. We never had people, Slovenian people, doing stuff like this. This is like a countryside here. People here rush to do work in a Krka pharmaceutical and local Renault company and stuff like this. We don't have this kind of rock and roll going on here. The family that I am talking about, this Tramte family, these were more than just normal people, if you understand me. They were more than just normal people. This were as normal, beautiful family as they possibly can be. But this is how it's done. He says that, however, they were gone down because it was a transaction. It was a financial transaction. He would resell him a car that he purchased for far less money than what he would sell one to him and stuff like this. I don't buy this. I mean, there might be something like this. There could have been, but the amounts of money were so small that, and for that matter, you have a court and so on, that something like this would not even go through, really. It was some other stuff that went on.
Kako se ti tega gospod?
Tramte.
Tramte?
Povše jih je pa postrelil.
Povše jih je pa postrelil?
Ja.
Ampak ta gospod Tramte je bil mehanik?
Ne, on je bil pregas...
Povše shoot them. He shoot them. Okay, that I don't understand, because the guy that, according to MK Ultra, was basically their neighbor. The thing is that they might have twisted the story around. I have to find out this stuff myself. Like I said, Mrak restaurant, Donald Trump spent a lot of time over there. Did they come up with the stuff? And there would be a possibility that he would be from the other side of the village? From completely other side of the village? Maybe. Maybe. I'm not even denying. I'm not even saying this stuff. I'm not saying this is not possible. I'm not saying they gave me the wrong information. Brainwashed me completely so I would get the wrong information. Poche, who shoot these people, one thing I'm going to tell you, I was told 100 times, was related to Belgrade. He was, I don't know, in the military over there, down there. I don't know what the hell he was doing, but he spent a lot of time down there. This is basically what I was told. So that he would be eventually from completely another location here somewhere, from here somewhere. As we go back, he indicates me a home here. I don't even know where. Along here someplace, he indicates me a home. There must have been them here somewhere, something like this. I don't know how that would be possible. It's the way I see it. It's the way I was explained this during my absence, during MK Ultra. And I am at this point in time, I am gonna publish this thing. Then I'm maybe gonna go even in the search, go deeper into this stuff. But right now, I'm not gonna even go into it. What I did fail to mention to you is that in because this house was like a year after, because the son spent time in the jail, so that probably I am talking the facts here. Financial situation and everything, somebody else purchased this home here. And what he would do is he would turn this into some kind of business, basically. He has some kind of business he would put it on inside in here. And this business already would come to life, probably I estimate sometimes already, maybe even back sometimes in 2004. How about this? And this is still the time when I'm not supposed to know absolutely anything about anything, because between the 1995 till mid 2006, I was in United States of America and absolutely nowhere. So you got about 2004, sometime like this, maybe 2005, 2004, some kind of renovation going on, and they opened some kind of business in there, in the house I'm talking about. And that's basically house, this one here, behind that you see it, right? And then also this man somehow also, after a while also, I understand, I don't know what happened, he went out of the business. So this is the way we're gonna do this stuff. This is another credit you're gonna give me, you understand?
Quanto ne vem, ki je čisto, ki je bil. V glavnem on kakšne pizdarije velik dela, tudi v Kamulom pa tako, pa veliko arestov.
The boy, I understand, turned into a criminal, German says. He became like a career burglar. He started to burglarize houses.
Je še bil velik časa.
So they got him in a criminal pattern.
Polše se piše.
Ne, ta se Tramte piše.
Tramte.
Se pravi...
Polše was the one who killed him. Tramte is the family I'm talking about.
Se pravi, sin je preživo,
ja, pa še dve ščirke sta.
Pa dve ščirke sta.
Ja, ena ba enega Benetika.
There is one sister more that is left around, and she got married to a gentleman, to one of the local people here.
Ma enega Benetika, je tudi na Ratežu tam hišo.
Benetika?
Benetika, Marija.
Benetik.
Ja.
Ja, ampak tu so se pa tu je že zdavne delač nazaj,
ja,
tu se poročilo.
Very...
At this point in time, I just explode. I no longer can hold on to it. You know, at this point in time, what's going on with me, I process the information. I process the information as fast as I could so I can catch him and make a statement that is going to confirm that I was actually here. That I have advanced knowledge of all this. Obviously, stuff I've stated to you, obviously I have. This is about 7 days ago when this thing was recorded. No, I was not there ever since. No. So... He's almost tried to cut me and tell me when. This was, as I said, blah, 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 but this was way back. And he said, yeah, this was, I said, wait. I say, but this already happened 20 years ago. He says, yes, supposedly. No. Today I'm going to tell you this happened exactly in 97. You understand? That's about 24 years back in time. 24 years back in time that I remember to the last detail. How about that? This isn't bad for somebody that is drugged up, huh?
Spomnim jaz. Samo mene tukaj ni bilo uradno.
Ja, verjamem.
Uradno me ni.
He says, but he confirms me this. He says, but officially, I said, officially I was nowhere here. I was nowhere here. Officially.
Po pričevanju
iz Amerike.
I tell him, yeah, they brought me here from America, but supposedly I was not here. Yeah, this is a note for the people. Supposedly I was not here ever. ever. I suppose it was never out of the United States of America. Supposedly from United States, out of the United States of America, I was twice. Twice in the country called Ecuador. Twice. And one time I crossed to the city Laredo, that's Mexico, northern part of Mexico. It's called Nuevo Laredo, a new Laredo from Laredo, and that was basically on foot. Just a few kilometers right across the Mexican border and back, so just so I could see a border. That's basically how I was doing, a truck driving. I was bored, and rather than to sit inside of the truck, I took a hike to Mexico to get an idea about Mexico. It's beautiful, I like it. So other than that, never ever was I out of United States of America for entire 11 and a half years, yet I was all over the world. I wasn't in China and in Japan and in South Africa. I was the man who met Eugene Terblanche and Nelson Mandela. I was in South America, in Argentina, and in Brazil, and of course in Canada and US and all over the US. Not only Miami, like supposedly would be the case. From 1995 to mid 2000 and actually, excuse me, like 2003, that's when I went to the school for the trucking, and I did draw all over the US. I'm not supposed to be anywhere in the US from 95 to 2003, yet I was already all over the US. I was already all over the LA, I was already all over the Washington State, Ohio, and Illinois, and Maine State, and New York, and so on and so forth. All over the place already. Let's go.
Who has the card with me?
The Americans?
Politic.
And Sweden, and Germany, and Norway, and Finland, and France, and Italy, and so on and so forth.
Political card with me, I see the guy with me. Takude, to se pa spomni, to se pa spomni, pa sta še skupaj.
Ke sestra od tega, ki je bil streljen,
ja.
Tramteta je pa tudi v Ameriki bila.
The sister from this, the man, the gentleman, when I displayed my competence about it, when he sees that I know what I'm talking about, that he feels that I gained attraction, you know, he is kind of released, you know, because this is my man. He says his sister, she also, from the Tramte, she also was in America. I am going to replay this, so I want to explain, translate word by word to you.
Nekaj sta handlala, pa je ta Tramte, kukar on ga nekaj okul prinesel, isto isto pišto.
Se piše.
Ne, ta se Tramte piše.
Tramte. Daleč nazaj,
ja,
se
to je
poročila. Čakaj, tu se je zgodilo kdaj, pred 20 leti.
Recimo, ja. Ne,
tu se spomnim jaz. Samo mene tukaj ni bilo uradno.
Ja, verjamem.
Uradno me ni bilo.
Aha, ampak po pričevanju drugih.
Amerikanci so me pripeljali tukaj, ja, iz Amerike. Se veste, kaj je bilo tukaj.
Ja, Amerikanci.
Politika, kaj je bilo tukaj, kaj se je dogajalo tukaj. Tako da, tu se pa spomnim. Tu se pa spomnim, pa sta še skupaj.
Ke sestra od tega, ki je bil streljen,
ja.
Tramteta je pa tudi v Ameriki bila.
He says the sister from Tramte, therefore from the brother who spends his time mostly in the jail. The sister, she still have a sister here in Ratež, she also was in America. That means that the girl might have actually even returned back here to Slovenia. That's an interesting one. It might have happened so that it did not work out for her at all in the US.
Sestra od Tramteta je tudi v Ameriki bila, sestra od njega.
Njega starejša.
Se pravi, tu imaš eno sestro in ona je bila v Ameriki.
Ja.
Pa ne mende v Miami, ok.
Ja,
meni se zdi, kaj je bilo tisto...
Ok, so I said... I said, but not possibly that she was in Miami, because I remembered that there was a girl, and I said, yes, I said, that's the one. But I say, no, I said, no, not in Miami, Fort Myers, Naples, that's basically on the other side of the Florida. Okay, this is already such a proximity that you can give, boom, another credit, but don't worry about it. On this tape, at the end of this tape, as I walk away, we go apart from the gentleman, I sort it out and I put in sequence, no, I say clearly, you're going to hear me saying, and the whole tape is at hand. In Miami, not in Fort Myers, not in St. Petersburg, whatever, in Miami, so in North Miami. So that's that, basically. So that's another, you give me another credit for that. Let's go.
St. Petersburg.
I had no idea she returned back. I had no idea she returned back. I am a little bit, I gotta think about that stuff. I did not even heard this whole thing.
Je na drugi strani Miamija, na drugi strani Florida.
Ne vem, kaj ne poznam isto Amerike tako podrobno, veš?
He says, I don't know because I don't know America so in detail, he says.
Podrobno, veš?
He does.
Če ko si pa že ona pisala, je imela slovenski princ?
Če se spomnim na to vse. In tu je bilo tudi...
I said, say I remember her. He says, I'm trying to recall what her last name was. It was also Slovenian name. Also, and I said, no, I said, don't worry about it, because I already recall that. I remember all that stuff.
I'm diabetes 2002.
Is that in
November? You're going to die 2002. Yeah, very
I said, so this happened in year 2002. And he says, yes. He says, yes, possibly 2002. I want to be precise about it. I would say 2001 it was. 2002, yeah, because she would come back. But in 2001, she was already in America with a money-making deal. Okay, now, do you want to know how she purchased the house? She purchased the house. That's another, you can give me another stamp here. It was not an apartment, that was a house. That was done through the real estate agency. And it was the kind of stuff I wanted to do because I was a real estate agent in the U.S. And I was like, stuff that I was doing, wait a minute, I got a license in 2001. Oh, so now I can give you a proper estimate. That must have happened in 2002, the latest in 2003 that she got the deal. So I say 2003, let's say. It was a piece of cake for her. I will still stick with the 2002, the latest. For the real estate agent, she would come with a down payment, puck, they would give her a house, and that was a large down payment. Large down payment. And that was her house, like this, basically.
Od v tej hiši, ko je bila tako iz Amerike prišla, so čist drugi ljudje.
Mega sred.
Ja.
About the house, I already have explained everything about the house. This is the house here, and I have already explained to you that house went out on the market. This boy lost this house. Yes, other people moved in. And then probably another people move in, right? Even individual I'm talking about who would refurbish this house sometimes in 2004 into some kind of store, 2005, that he would put the store here. This was already third person. If the parents were the first, then it was another people that would purchase, and then then he was the one who purchased it. This was a very, very somehow unlucky house, I would say. It could have been also that this was, I don't know, from the sister, son, I don't know what the case was, but I think it was not, something like this, okay? So this is, you can just write the credits more and more and more.
Cheers. Kdo bi bil pa na Ratežu? Še da bi mehanik bil, pa da bi oče samomor naredil.
Oče pa samomor naredil.
He says he would not know who else would be a mechanic in Ratež, and that father would make a commit a suicide. He wouldn't know.
Pa samomor naredil. Da se ga obtožijo, se ga. In...
It doesn't come to him. He says, it's possible, but it doesn't come to me.
Yeah.
In kuk naj bi ta fant bil zdaj star, ko pravi, da
je
ta auto
prepravljalo? Star je pa tam zdaj kot 20 let.
Zdaj
le
20 let?
Ja, mlad
je se. Ask me about the boy, what his age would be. I said, this is a 20-year-old.
Mlad je se.
It doesn't come to me that he's got about at least 5-year-old brother, older brother, because I would tell him this, but it didn't came to me until I actually did this whole video, you know?
Right,
yes, sir. With the auto-prevoznik, Kovačič Klemen, Transport Klemen, ma napisano na kamioni.
This is yet another individual, another company that also opened, but that was later after that company, another company opened. We can get to that. Like I said, I know the whole area. Despite my absence, that supposedly I spent time in the U.S. only, I know the whole area. It would be like, I would be here almost all the time. Especially it was like this because people would update me. These people loved me. They updated me.
For Mercurio.
Samo drugi
sečela vol. Te pa groza, super pa sečem, pa te pa, tu me pa zvije, totalno.
Ja,
še spomnim, da teh zadev, tu je še kuš.
Ja, prišel je zjutraj ta moža, kar ima žago doma, se še zdaj. Za hlode žagat, za dele, pa je prišel na žago, on povšenje pa dol, v dolin, za potokem, gor, prv njega ustrelil, pa žena vam prletela.
Ja, da je tako, no, to je zdaj še kuša.
The location that a gentleman, that I heard the gentleman stating to me is exactly this one here. This was the man who would do this kind of business. The house, according to him, is next to this stream here. So this is the way this is. So this is, you gotta admit, huh? This is one of a kind, huh? Eventually, the political boys from Ljubljana and Belgrade believed that they're gonna cash in this, that I would not know, and this and that, and so on. Yeah. And that this is what will cost me everything. Well, not likely, not likely. I said, I told him that this whole thing was so mad, I said I didn't. You would not think that this is possible, stuff like that. This is horrific. He said, and then he tells me about somebody lately that, I don't know what, again, there was some other murder. In Slovenia, this stuff is frequent. Bad things are happening all the time.
Jaz sem slišal zdaj nekaj, da
sem jo vse povedal. 35
let staro partner kupil pa njene starše.
I tell him instead, yes, I remember. I remember the whole thing. This thing was a nightmare, you know. I when they told me this stuff, I told him this, for me, this was a nightmare. The traumas were in MK Ultra. There was no MK Ultra ever. Whenever I was brought there, you would not go through like completely insane traumas. In Czech Republic, literally seeing men that one of the loveliest people I can think of end up with a hole in the throat in Bohumins. People dying here, people dying there, people throwing them inside of the mental hospital in Poland, here in Czech Republic. Killings, domestic violence, killing here, killing there. In Slovenia the same. Okay. Imagine like a street mob, like a street gang. This was all the time the environment I spent. when handlers would guide me through these dots, you know, they would have dot 1 3, this is what he have to visit for as long as we stay here. Then we go to another location, they go to meeting to some other place, take me with them, have a local handlers over there, and again the same thing would repeat. Then you would get this street alike attitude from people. They would like know, you know, time wise when they're going to bring you, what time you're going to come to the city, this and that. Then they will come to you, and all kinds of stuff that you possibly can imagine. Take you to some abandoned buildings, death threaten you, stuff that I'm not going to even put. Some stuff I recorded, locations and stuff like this, I'm not going to even probably put this stuff on the internet. Somebody claimed that when something like this would get to attention, was very, very upset that it was a recording that circled around in private. Yeah, there would be a very, very, very bad stuff. There would be very, very, when people would see this, that it was just what the stuff they were doing to me, you don't have any kind of idea about the stuff. Now, the thing about me is that what people were doing to me, this was nothing. KGB in Russia, in Moscow, they were like, they could not understand my attitude. Because I was repentless, I was merciless. They would threaten me like with death all the time. It was all the time that you're gonna be dead at any time. And all these people, they would not even hide how they do it to the people. And you're gonna be at just about any time, and if you're gonna say this and this and this and that. And they could not understand why is it that I'm sure due to a number of people they did got in their hands, that I showed no mercy for anything. I was repentless and I would just keep going without absolutely any kind of compassion, without any kind of whatever they had to say. I would not change. You could tell me, I don't know, in one moment you could you could have a dog barking at me that he's gonna tear me apart. Maybe 10 minutes later down the road I would insult somebody in such a way that he would, I don't know, take it home and go and cry about it for 10 years without mercy, drugged up as I was, without mercy. And they couldn't understand any of that kind of stuff. They could not get any of that kind of stuff. In Moscow, I don't know if I mentioned that stuff, Putin and his son-in-law and Lavrov, they had some other younger with them. They would take me on the outskirts of the Moscow. There was a lot of snow. I don't know what year was it. I estimate the year probably was about, like, I suppose, like 2003 or something like this, 2004. And there was a snow. I don't know how much snow was it. It was so bad, it was not about maybe like 30, 40 centimeters snow, but it was 40 centimeters snow was. And in the side of the car, they would have me in, it appeared to be in underwear. In a long underwear, and they had a jacket, and we would come out of the car, and they would wear a camouflage, you know, like a camouflage jackets and stuff like that. And I was drugged up, and they pulled me out of the car. Let's go. In some kind of snow on the field out there, it was a forest around. Now we're gonna see how tough you are, and taking the jacket down. Yeah, take your jacket down. He said, no, so what? And one of them would go and just plaff like this, something like this, pluck, give me like, boom, like this, slap, something like this. I say, oh, okay, I see, I see. And it was, I don't know how many, maybe six of them, ha ha ha. Boy, in one moment, I started to run after them and I wanted to beat the fuck out of them, excuse me on my expression. It was no mercy, snow, cold, whatever it was, drugged up. I didn't care even a little bit. They were a little bit in shock. It didn't come to them. They did not understand where all that stuff is coming from. I was repentless, just as I'm repentless today. Nothing ever changed.
Jo, kam boš ti zdaj krenil?
Jaz zdaj malo sprohodim se tole gor.
Ja, jaz idem tja, da bom krok naredil. Ma kurva, tako je drsil.
Kje pa gre se mi do Rateža nazaj?
Ja, jaz bom šel zdaj.
Okay, I'm gonna go back and so we decided we're gonna go back together, right? This is like, really, we met right where this car is, and I demonstrated earlier to you, and not too far from there, about like maybe 50 meters, we do this conversation, and we decide we're gonna go back to his places. I was gonna go, and I was gonna wish a new year to this family here at Ratež, right? That's what I was gonna do. And so I said, what a nice man. I said to myself, maybe I can get some more information along the way too. Let's go.
No, ter v tisti jar, pa gor pa po.
Pa grem z vam, jo. Lahko gremo skupaj.
Ja, lahko.
Jaz sem se to zdravil, da sem na Ratežu. Ne
grem zdaj, da bom si tle, da bom se v tisto jamo
prilagal. Pošte tem sveto novo leto.
Hvala in
pa sem, pa sem.
Look, I am still not 100% about him. I am trying to sort him in time. I'm trying to feel him in time. I know that he was all the time in MK Ultra, but it doesn't, he's a person. He's so familiar to me, but I'm trying to grab myself, hold myself onto something. That's how it works. It does not come immediately to you. It does not come immediately. So we walk along the way back.
Hotel sem je tukaj 6, pa meni nekako v štelu, je blata tam gor. Ampak to ne gre po cesti, ne gre to po cesti.
Bomo šlati jaz skupaj
po cesti. Po cesti greste?
Kaj?
Pa ni tam tisti automobili, drvijo, norijo gor, pa dol tisto.
Ja, kurva, da kaš, dol v jam je pa hodil, veš.
V jam je pa zale voda, ne da?
Ja, se bojim, da je preveč blata.
It's like this, I already was there. I went walking for the first time. I was gonna go there and I saw the cars, boom, 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 just as I would come to the road. Just as I would come to the road right here, to this place here, I saw the cars going back and forth and I said, no, I'm not going. I'm not going. And I went back. I said, I'm going to go back here. So as I head back here to this car here, I meet the gentleman and we decide, in fact, to go back again. So now, since he's going to go, I'm going to have a company. I said, yeah, why not? Let's go. Let me go and wish Happy New Year. Almost, I would say, to my family here on Ratež.
Ne, ne, ne. Bomo šla do Gumbrka, do prve hiše, bomo šla po hod zdaj.
Ja.
Bom šest pa po cest.
Ja. Pa ni bolj šla le jaz čest, če zato, če smo gor šla le, ker si gremo Ratež.
Ja, ne, jaz grem tle, če ne
zato sem.
Ne, se greš ti lahko ono pot svoje, ker smo izdali.
Ma jaz sem z vami, štemo, prejmo skupaj, štemo. A, jaz se tu nič nekikiram za tukaj, se meni tole, lejte, tukaj, kaj grem jaz, kaj se mi v serije tole, to jaz tako naredim, da čele, čele.
Guys, if you do happen to have a hiking shoes and it's just awfully a lot of mud, you don't want to wash them every day. Not only because they get wet and they're not going to get dry by tomorrow. But I've seen others that would scratch them with brushes and stuff like that, and the only thing they would do is they would destroy plastic and everything. you don't, you do this, you use one for the mud and you use another one for the city. And when the springtime is, or when it's get like really, really dry and this and that, then you clean them nicely. And they are just like the day you purchased them. And I try to explain this to him because he's complaining about his shoes. Now, his shoes are really interesting to me anyways. No, I will not tell you why.
Če vas bom priporočil, da si kupi. Samo na tam, kjer smo Decathlon v Ljubljani.
I think this shoes in Ljubljana in a Decathlon, they cost you 11 euros only. And they're good, but the secret is the one I told you. You put some insoles inside and you do just like I told you, not to clean them every time you use them. And they'll be like new, and they're just fine, soft and nice, everything is okay.
On, and I stay over to some more. They, samo številko svoje treba vedeti, pa se jih prek interneta naroči.
Jaz tu tudi sopata, pa tu fino povodim tudi
obok. The gentleman, I love the gentleman, he is just talking about his shoes, that the shoes are so great that he has, and I know why. He is like the best shoes, he says, it's so nice, these shoes are so just awesome, they are so great, my shoes, he says, I will not say why.
Dobro spredaj. Tole bom rekel takole, nič nisem mogel.
He says, I'm more than satisfied with my shoes. I'm sure he is.
Druga stvar je pa ta, da jaz jih ne pušam več.
His shoes are under no circumstances any kind of new shoes, if you get me. At least closely, if you get me.
Jaz, ko poglasko odim z njimi, se zato sem naročil še ena za mesto. Ko poglasko odim z njimi, pustim tako, kar je. Zaradi tega, ker enkrat so se puča tu,
I just keep writing down. This is when I identify him. He says he went with excursion to a Czech Republic. Write down. I stated at the beginning of the video, I did identify him as well. Of course I did.
Ja, seveda, zaradi tega, da ti ne varnosti, ne? Da ti ne pade karkoli, da ne bi blokej.
He says, I went to the Czech Republic with the engineers, a group of engineers, right? We went to the Czech Republic, and they gave us shoes. A safety shoes, such a hard shoes. And I said, no, these are a safety shoes, it must be like this, so, so that they keep you safe if anything falls on your feet or something like that. This man is a lot about shoes. And yeah, back then, I'm just gonna put it this way, I was with him when this, I don't know if it did happen. It did happen to him, I was not there, but it happened to him again, so that because he would come back, so he repeated it. They would repeat this stuff inside of this factory, and so that I would remember. That was in the Czech Republic.
Yeah.
And they were completely new, and the bottom of the shoes just fell off to me, he says, in the middle of the factory. Something like this, he says, in the Czech Republic.
Sredo varni.
Ja.
Danes sem poplačil z ljudi.
Kako pravite?
V sredo pa brinke sem poplačil z ljudi.
Odplate ste zgubo... Usred fabrike.
I am a little bit surprised.
Usred fabrike.
Fabrike
na Češkem.
He says that he was embarrassed, he said. It was so difficult to me. I said, I see, and it comes to me immediately. I already see a big factory. What I see in my head is a big factory. But I don't say anything about it. I see a big factory. It was like a wide open, huge, ample space. And I remember us group with the Czech people inside. So I know now this was a big factory. And so you happened to you this to you, I told him in 2003, I tell him. He said, well, he said, I am thinking, I'm not sure, I'm thinking. It was later on, he said, it was later on, he says. He says, in 2005, I went into retirement.
Yeah. But stabil, ne, takrat.
Just a moment.
V 2005?
Ja.
Ja. Ampak stabil, ne, takrat.
He says in 2005 it appears that this happened to him in 2005. It's like this. Maybe my memory is better than his. I don't agree with it. I agree with the stuff what he said. He said that it happened to him probably 2005. Yes, I agree with it. But it was not the first time he was in this factory. That I know it was not. I know that he was already there at least in 2003 in this big Czech factory where I actually was, you know when? In 1995 already.
Kaj bo 2003?
Ja, ta pa ve.
Aha. Aha.
So I go for 2003 and he says, he admits that he would come back to Czech Republic, but that this happened to him, it looks like in 2005. I am very uncomfortable and very determined on 2003. I know about his retirement. I know, I remember it was a retirement. But I also know that this, with the Czech people and this and that, that he started to travel earlier. It was about 2 years before the retirement he would start to travel to the Czech Republic. I know this, and I know I'm not mistaken. Okay, so the shoe sole have fallen him down in the middle of this factory, as he states, in 2005. But he was there already 2003, for sure. He says how a river is such a high current, strong current. I said, this is the most beautiful river in the world. Said, I've not seen a river more beautiful than this one. And I said, it depends how the river feels like. It depends on the weather, how it suit, how the weather suits one. That's how the river feels like, if I translate to you from Slovenia.
Je pa tole poteca, poved se da plava kilometre in kilometre po nej, pa tudi po zimšele noč toči. Tudi po zimšele malo plavljeno.
Res?
Ja.
Now, he's asking about the local people here in my village in Onakirka. I didn't get there yet. This is who was not involved in my village in this MK Ultra? Few people. Very few people that would not. It was like a person that would not know about it. Everybody knew about this stuff. The doctor I have mentioned, the doctor from Bosnia, I am not going to go to that subject just yet. I will get to that subject to you some other time.
What a wazzle. Yeah?
Asking me about people from the village, to tell you the truth, I almost kept no relationship with them. To tell you the truth, for me, the situation was very, very difficult. In a situation as I was so embarrassed, for one thing. In front of the people here from village, it was very difficult for me to go out there. But I know that these people kept their fingers crossed all the time for me. These people prayed for me a lot, more than what I initially thought. It was politicians like this that made mess. But that doesn't mean that people hated me at the same time. I was surprised whenever they put me on a picture, we would meet. They would get to see me, this and that. But in real life, I was so tense. It was all kinds of awesome pleasantries that were involved. But I don't take this hard. I don't take this to my heart because I feel that there is more to these people than whatever the politicians decide in them. For me, they're just... Actually, they're better. I feel better about them than the day I moved to this village from the city. I think that we got a special relationship now. That they formed with me more like family kind of relationship. That we are more than just people from the same village because of this. I think that they got all the people here. I would say, including the people that would move to this place from Serbia, it was a political pressure like this that they brought literally people from Serbia and they would move them to the village and to the other villages. I think these people, as evil, they saw me, and I also gave my best to look as such. I think they started to grasp there is more to life than just the politics and the stuff that they definitely were 100% certain about me is not actually, in reality, this is not exactly the picture. I think that I gotta say that a lot of the Serbians, I have disappointed them tremendously in probably from 2017 up. Because from 2017 up, it became evident that I don't actually have any kind of problem, that I don't have any kind of hatred towards Serbian people. It became clear, it became obvious that there is something else going on here. It's a misinformation. The worst thing about all this stuff is that if the politicians felt that I came closer with my interests to their area, like in 2006 when I came from the US, And I was literally looking for a date in Belgrade through online dating and stuff like this. Excuse me, but they went fucking ballistic. They went ballistic. Their hair went up. They lost it. They lost it because it's a lot of Serbian people in Serbia. It's a lot of Serbian people in Serbia that loved me. I was in Serbia back and forth, and once the people got to know me, some people have chosen to see whatever they want to see it. I did also stuff that, like I said, in this whole process, I don't think I have faced thousand traumas because of all kinds of shit, because of dead people here, dead people there, the death threats, the women, thousand women, when they tell you that they're interested in you and then they appear with another man, sometimes engaging in indecent stuff in front of you as a retaliation and all kinds of stuff like this. And then some kind of insane scenarios to make you paranoid and stuff like this, to make you mad, to make you believe things that are related to hell that don't exist, so that you would not see, not only to make you paranoid, but so that you would not see the real stuff, and it's a really big concern. All kinds of stuff like this, but I am, as far as the people, not the politicians, I am mad at politicians, but as far as people, I am not taking mad at anyone. Now, if somebody's got a problem with me, based on what I have stated to you, based on what I explained, I have gone through, that's then a different story. Then we can settle the differences. I don't have a problem with that. That kind of attitude, I don't have a problem with it. But against the people that I would go, because somebody yesterday, I don't know, death threatened me and did all kinds of stuff and I don't know what and this and that, that I don't have a problem with. But if I would see one doing funny stuff now, I would actually ask him about it. I would want to know more about it. And then we can also settle the differences, like I said. Otherwise, in general, I have no problem whatsoever. This is just the way it is. Much better relation than the day I moved, to this place from the city. And I'm actually looking forward, once this is finished, just as I explained, gentlemen, to expand this relation, to see my homeboys here from the village, like used to be in old times, when we would go for a swimming here and, you know, do our things. The boys from the Czech Republic, from the Bohemian, and also from Poland and so on. This is just the way it is, but especially here from village, it's very, very important to me. This is not just like this. I don't take this lightly. These people went through a terror. You're going to hear recordings. People escaped from the village. They would escape to undisclosed locations. If I would ask them, where are they, relatives, they would not want to disclose. They are afraid. And so on and so forth. You don't understand what is this shit, this political stuff. And not because they would be afraid of me. They were afraid of those uncles that would do the cleansing. Not me.
Nisem z njim imel kontakte tam v vasi tudi, vem pa veliko o soferih. In to je na žalost, da nisem bil v kontakte. Zato upam, da po prihodnosti, da bom bil več z njim v kontakte.
Yeah, I hope in the future we're gonna expand this relations with the people. I am looking forward to that. He says, I tell him, why don't you go and enroll yourself in some, you know, fireman association or something like this, local. And I'm trying to say to him, man, I have my spine broken, but I don't know how I would explain to him that I would love to be a fireman. I would love to help a volunteer fireman. But he says, but you can, I don't even explain to him any of this. And he says, and you're going to, what you're going to do is you can go and you can you can collect money from the people for the association, a fees for the firemen. He mentions the money. I tell him, I think this money, I'm afraid, I tell him, does more damage than good. I think that we have too much money here in Slovenia, and that I'm not going to go into it. I already have explained about that money. Some they have more money than, you know, can imagine. Others they have nothing, and so on and so forth. This money does more evil than good, I tell him.
Dobro.
Če bi bil razdeljen,
to je poen,
da bi se ljudi v...
Ja, dobro, da imam tukaj fatra.
He says if the money would be equally divided to all the people and this and that. This is like an old-fashioned man. Maybe a little bit communist, I don't know. He is just like a social justice-oriented individual. He's not a communist, but this is people from my country are still more like social way. And this is an older guy and you'll learn more.
Okay.
There is. That is correct. I had correct and he had correct. Okay, I had correct because he said that he retired. I understood that he retired in 2005. When he mentioned retirement something in 2005 and this and that, I was sure that I understood that 2005. And previously, I mentioned to you that he already started to go to Czech Republic about 2 years earlier than his retirement. Now he tells he retired in 2007. That's why I was sure before he was in Czech Republic in 2003. Now he said the shoes that he think that they fell off to him in 2005. Okay, I'm gonna tell you what. It was, if he retired in 2007, he went to the Czech Republic in 2005. First, 2004, 2005. Twice he went to the Czech Republic before his retirement. And the shoes, if I properly remember, should have fallen to him, therefore, during the first year of retirement. That was not even in 2005, that should be like in 2007. I will explain to you all how it all works. He says, now this is a really interesting one. Really interesting one. In 2005, this man, because of the stuff that went on, a lot of people would just give up. They were afraid, like you have no idea, because people die here, people die there. The guy said to him, it did have to do with something with the police. We lost a lot of people. And we got to recruit more people to help in this and that. And he said, I'm going to be one of them for sure. Well, geez. That was actually before 2005. What is interesting is they set him up. Soon after that, they set him up. I'm going to play that thing again. He, however, was not certain where they set him up. 2005 was the first time, not the first time, it was one time before, like in 2003, that he already went into the Czech Republic. 2005 he was like officially going to the Czech Republic. This was like officially Czech Republic. Just about, I think in 2007, something like this, as he would return from the Czech Republic, I don't know, maybe already in 2005, 2006, before he would go to retirement, because it was on a table, Renault here, factory Renault, Revoz, and the place in the Czech Republic. He said, I don't know where, but they fucked me up. They fucked me up. And they said, what do you mean they fucked you up? They did not in a majority cases from the beginning when it all started. The biggest thing was cancer, and you would have a shootout like this. But for the most part, it was a cancer. But later on, they have found different tools and they have diversified stuff they have used, because they no longer could go just cancer. They started to produce different things. This guy was actually the first guy that I know of also. They would do something to him that affected his nerves, his neural system. I have no idea that something had to do with some kind of poison that would affect neurological system, that he had a terrible problem with the nerves. He did not suffer absolutely anything, and he did not know where that thing happened. But as soon as he would go to the Škoda factory, that I could tell you, oh shit, I shouldn't have said that. That's supposed to be that place, and I do identify that in continuation. But as soon as he went over there, he said he lost his health. He would come back, and as soon he was not, he wouldn't be the same. He was like, not that this would happen in the Czech Republic, but when he would come back from the Czech Republic in 2005, therefore, within a period like 6 months or something like this, he said, when we saw each other, when they had me, that he is feeling terribly sick, that he doesn't know what it is, that whether that in a Czech they had somebody that they talk, that they give some kind of information to someone about him or something like this, or it actually happened to him here in Slovenia in Renault. Well, you know, this is the way it is. And this video, series of video about the Ratež, I titled them with a very, very good reason as Ratež Novo Mesto Political Massacre in Independent, in a parenthesis, Independent, Slovenia, after 1995. When I said that I am going to demand a statue dedicated to our people for what they have gone through after 1995, I mean this. And that's serious about that. I am going to repeat this, so we're going to get this clearly. So from 2005 you're retired. No, he says from 2007. He says the nerves got me, but I explain you everything, absolutely everything, timing wise I explain to you everything. It was to be with a complete precision. Yes, most likely it was in 2003. In 2003, that one time he would go to Czech Republic only once with a Czech team, one time, and then in 2005 he would go to the Czech Republic, and then when he retired he would go back again. Then he would have more time and he would travel. He said, I had a problem with the nerves. I got my nerves became sick with the nerves. I don't even know what happened, he said. He said, I had no will for life. I had no will for work. I did not know what went on.
Makro,
Okay, 100%, I stated, he mentioned 95, it was like a 6 month period from his return, something like this, from Czech Republic, and that he says in, from 2005 until he says, oh my God, I don't know, 2013 or something like this, he says, that's like 8 years. I had suffered and suffered and suffered and suffered and suffered with my nerves. This actually is stuff. For that kind of stuff, all you need is a chemical agent. And they have all kinds of military agents, and that's what that is. So we will do the stuff like this to you.
Okay. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
He does not dare to say that they poisoned him. He is not anywhere open as he was with me during Antiotra. He does not go into any of, he does not state, does not even touch conspiracy of any kind. He does not go into that area. He says that they work, they operated 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. They had three shift system, and he was ahead of this operations. Or through, he also explains in a way, in continuation, that is like, not really, that would not be possible. That. Year and a half before his retirement, that he would all of a sudden, after all everything he have gone through as a head of this, all of a sudden he would get some kind of, it's very funny, you got to hear this.
Jaz sem bil pa edini, ne?
Yeah.
In ni bilo važno, ki bo problem, v pol način me poklicati, kateri put. Pa nisem čutil, da je to neko obremenito, veš?
He said it didn't matter if I, they call me midnight or whatever to come and this and that. He said I never felt any problem with it. I never felt any anything like this. And then all of a sudden it struck me.
Mislite, da je to bilo?
Ja, le, ne vem. Drugega ne nisem ustavil, doma
sem. Jaz sem takih stvari počel.
Says, I personally, he says, I am never doing anything other, as I ask him, do you think that's what it was? He says, I tell him, I used to do all kinds of stuff, work around the clock, do all kinds of stuff I did, and, but of course I was young, I tell him, I'm not your age, but, you know.
Taki stvari je počel, nori kaj ne bomo to delo, in tako naprej. Pa je pa to vas fizično, ki je bilo, ali je bilo samo tako psihično, ali kaj?
Ja, lej, no, nič ne apetite za jest, ne volje do dela, ležo, bolj se bi trudil.
He says he didn't have no will for life. He was not even hungry. The more he said he laid down, the more he was tired. He says he said like this. He said, no, I told him, yeah, I said this, but this is the way it works. When you are not active, the more you lay down, when you are older, that's what you become sluggish and this and that. That's basically what happened. This is the kind of stuff that happens to the people that go through the career, and then they go to retirement, and once they go to retirement, they completely collapse because they just... wait for this retirement to come. They don't move much during their period of employment, but once they get to retirement, this is situation with the state jobs. I've seen people, let's say it, when I worked for the state in Florida, they would die as soon as they would go to retirement because it was a lack of that exercise, dynamic life, and so on. The job basically absorbed them completely. But he says, no, he said, no. From 2005 and 2007, they put me on a waiting list. That means that you are actually employed and not employed. You spend time at home collecting the checks, basically. And that really didn't make any sense, this whole thing. You see, so now he turns the other way. Now it's, he's still suggesting that this stuff not exactly normal, something like this. It was nothing like I suggested. So I said, and so in that case it was something else. He says it was not this thing that you would go from work into retirement. No, no, he said it did not have nothing to do with that. He says he accents that. Yeah, so not like this. The thing is, I wanted to make sure. I want to see things clearly as what, who wants to say what. So based on that, then also I can tell that other part. Otherwise, I can't. He says, and ever since, you are okay? He says, I am completely, completely perfect. One day, I got up, and it was like nothing ever, ever happened to me. I was all of a sudden in a perfect health. The only problem I have too many kilos. I tell him, I also have too many kilos. But he says, you know, but you're lucky because you're a tall guy. I says, you know what? I tell him, I also say like this. Every time when I see someone taller than myself, that's exactly what I say to myself, and we are both laughing. He says, and I say, and you like to eat? He says, he talks about the formula that weight is associated with a height and this and that. I completely agree. And he says, you like to eat good. And I said, you just ask me about that. He says, and the wife, she is a very good cook. He says, He says, I say, and when you were in a Czech Republic, I say, because I'm still thinking, I gotta get more, as many as possible proof as we walk. I remember this was a huge, huge factory. I said, this was a huge, huge factory. And he said, what factory was this? Was this a Škoda factory? Because I remember when we were standing out in this big platform inside of this factory. It was just huge, ample. And he says, yes, it was Škoda factory. I already told you about the Škoda factory. Škoda factory, Miloš Zeman thanked me personally for the Škoda, for existence of the Škoda factory. It was a Polonaise and it was a Škoda. The Polonaise, according to Merkel, would not, Polonaise is a Polish factory, would not want to listen to Germans. They would not want to obey Germans. Basically, they would not want to submit themselves. They were rebels. All through one time on the platform for the last Polonaise, they did got through my case, just like a Škoda got entire technology, entire modernization, everything, the money, everything through this case. They got this case because in 1995 Škoda got this money because I got into the fight into most severe arguments with, in front of Putin, with his people in Czech Republic. They were over, they had me over there, and I got into that. It was like an impression that it was like, I got an impression like, I did not know it was a effing mess. Where we are, this and that, what is going on, and this and that. And the guy said in the Czech Republic, because I hear this, the Ruskis was basically, they were holding me like this all the time. They wanted to like, you're gonna do this. No, I don't have nothing wrong. I don't have a problem with the Ruskis. I like Ruskis. But this was like a terror. This was like all the time holding me like this. And this is how you're gonna learn. This is how you're gonna, your life is gonna be based on some kind of fear, this kind of idea they had about me. There was no fear, boy. The first slap I gave to the Putin, to his delegation, was in Czech Republic, when I started to bitch, where are we? What are you talking about? Putin, they wanted all the industry, everything, all the investments immediately to Russia, everything, nothing to Czech Republic, nothing to Poland, nothing this. This is the impression I got. And I said, what are you talking about, this and that, that they're gonna... And I exploded over there. And Merkel decided to instead to give the modernization, the factory to Russia. They decided to revive Škoda. And for that matter, that was Miloš Zeman. He became like my like number one supporter from that moment, because Miloš Zeman worked in 1995 in the Czech Republic. There was nothing. Everything had fallen apart. Entire economy had fallen apart. Czech Republic, Czech people did not have anything they could eat from. The country was on its knees. The old Škoda did not have what it would take to produce the next generation of vehicles. The factory was about to close down. They did not have what it take to survive. Škoda Felicia modernization engines from Volkswagen, Škoda Octavia was launched out as the first one, and it was a very successful, totally German car. The two engineers, Czech engineers, whose cubicles I remember inside of the Czech Republic, they would take me and they would show me the models, exactly the kind of car they would choose based on what and this and that on a Škoda Octavia. And I can tell you, they did a very good choice. And this is how the Škoda Octavia, the first car, came to life, and Škoda factory survived. The Polonaise, who got the engine from Daihatsu, in case you wonder how you got this through this case, you got this through the Japanese, because you got through me, even the Polonaise. But you had a problem in Egypt, and that's the stuff you don't even know why and how and this and that. That's where it was based. You based the factory in Egypt and the whole, due to cheaper workforce and stuff like this. And the whole thing went down. It was many, many reasons for that. It was no way to avoid this closure. Polonaise, the last Polonaise they were producing, were actually a really decent car. So you're listening to the program, you're listening to a guy that actually really knows something about what went on inside of the factories in Western and Eastern, how they were making the combinations and so on. Yep, you're in the right place. So I would know something about the Škoda, but it was not, you know, it was not about that kind of stuff. It was some other stuff that it was based on when we were inside, you know. I remember when we would come, and it was like, I would look down, you know, and it was like ample. We were like on some kind of staircases, then we would come down, and it was like ample, and there was workers on this side, on that side, that would have these machines, and it was just ample. And he says this was in the middle of the factory, therefore, so this was a Škoda. They had me also in a Kia, I think they started to produce Kia in the Czech Republic too. That too happened, but that was in a late stage. I don't know, 2015 or 2017 when they started. It was like a completely robotic, automated process that they made it to. It was not by any chance Slovakia. That I'm not even sure. Czechoslovakia before. I'm not even sure. But Škoda, hey man. Miller Zeman promised me actually the top model car, a Superb, I would get from him. I never got one, I'll tell you. I never got that car. He was completely in love, and then he started to more and more bitch, maybe because of my attitude. Then he wanted to, like a Ruskis, he wanted to choke me too. He changed opinion about me because I started to create problems, more and more problems. Look, nobody wants to be drugged up. You want to be drugged up and next to watch basically a boy that came from South Africa who was a nobody who got to know me in South Africa? This is how Elon Musk came to America. How do you think Elon Musk got to America? I was in South Africa already in 96 and 97 already, all over the South Africa they had me. I told you about AWB. And the US government had investments in, in this and that, the interest. This is how Elon Musk learned about United States of America. This is how Elon Musk came to United States. You want to go? They say the other day, they say that he's the wealthiest man in the world. Do you want to be somebody who saw all these people making money like this, through this kind of case? You were in the middle of this, and you stay fucking nobody, pronounced as mentally ill, thrown inside of the mental hospital, and read the news for the next 26 years, how much money they make. You want to be like this? Let's continue with this. And Audi and Mercedes, I was there too. He said that Revoz, Renault here in Novo Mesto, has better organized factory than Škoda has over there in the Czech Republic. But this is related more to investments, you know. You know, this company here, actually our socialism in Slovenia was not as bad as the situation was in the Czech Republic. They were more starved. So naturally that we had this old tradition also, not as old as Škoda here in Slovenia. In Novo Mesto, we don't have this. We had a different factories. We had first here British company, Rover. This was a British company first. The Brits, they would pull our company in Yugoslavia here in Novo Mesto, they would assemble British automix. Simca was here, that's actually Chrysler, I think it was. They were doing strange kind of stuff. You would be like, from the Eastern Bloc, people would be like, how they got this kind of stuff, how this came to Novo Mesto, like, where are these cars coming from? They were not imported. They were assembled, built here in Novo Mesto, basically assembled together. Rover went away, but the French came. Renault came, and Renault stayed here since from forever. The Renault 4, legendary, and other cars before that. The Renault 5 and so on, they assembled them here. Many, many Renaults cars, Clios and so on, Twingos. This is the stuff that was done here. So, due to financial ability to already have a ritual, you know, they give you the machinery, a Renault 4 and a Renault 5 and all these cars. This is not really a joke. Already when I was in the school here in Novo Mesto and I was doing in Renault, I was with this mechanical engineering technician. When we would go inside of this Renault factory here in Novo Mesto, you already saw this robotic things going back and forth, this line of cars just going down, people working here quickly together, putting this stuff. They didn't dream about that stuff in the Czech Republic yet back then. You're talking about 90, you know, you're talking about actually, yeah, 89 and so on and so forth. This was already something completely different. they did not have the vision for this kind of stuff due to financial resources, but probably car wise, you know, Skoda is a really good cars. These are maybe better than the Renaults, I don't know. These are Volkswagen engines inside, but Renault cars are actually really good cars. He says what he says.
Okay. Kaj?
Vi ste pa to vse videli na svoje oči, ste pa lepo ocenili, ko ga se v Nemci dal dejansko, ja. Kaj je bilo. In ste ocenili, da to ni to, kar v bistvu
čeprav,
ima recimo Renault.
Čeprav ti avtomobili glede na...
I was just really very interested in mechanical engineering, because of the professional production, I wanted to know what exactly relation was financial investment wise. He realized that from my perspective, from what I estimate, his feedback, Germans did not invest the amount of money that would equal to probably French investments. But Slovenian taxpayers invested a lot of money in the Renault itself here in Novo Mesto, so the factory would go on. According to his opinion, this is probably because of what I have learned. Yeah, that's why probably. He says the Skoda cars are not bad at all. Despite all this, they're not bad at all. These are very good cars.
To so dobri automobili, ampak
kaj?
Investicije same to.
Mislim sama tovarna red pa tudi v revozu. Da ti pa ne rečem, jaz grem s tem društvom strojnih inženirjev in tehnikov. Vse sorte pogledat gremo.
Aha.
In ti moram reči, da ta...
Yeah, like I said, he is doing this already since 2005. Whatever he is talking about, this kind of society of the engineers that they travel around, they are doing this already since 2005.
Ta tovarna v Veliki Log, ko ima bašt, ki dela te razne podsklope, za...
The company I was at, I already identified one. You already have the video, I have already identified the company, everything. In Velika Loka, they had me over there too. In Slovenia, he says this is if you want to learn about the factory, how the factory, the modern factory, you don't have to go anywhere in the Europe, you can just go to him and you can learn everything. He says when I came inside of the factory was one thing, but when I went, and he talks about the robots, what kind of robot they have, robotic, everything is robotic. The only thing the human will do is if the robot cannot sense if the proper distribution of material is not it's not proportional to axis of work for the robot, a robot will sense an issue, error. But other than that, almost the humans are not necessary. He said, once I left the factory, I almost thought that it's, he said, first when I came in, I was sure that people make robots, but when I walk out of that factory, I wasn't sure. I had a feeling that a robot make the people.
Yeah.
If you want to go to see the factory, like the most, the top developed, all you have to go to him and see his factory, and then you see what kind of engineering that is inside. Well, the truth is that this is not our engineering. This is the same like with machines from Heidelberg, from Germany. It's a stuff that it's imported and then it's used here. I wish our people would learn more. This is my wish, that our people would learn more about this robotic stuff and started to produce the machines, the robots itself here in Eastern Europe, all over the Eastern Europe. That's what I would like to do. That's why I ask these questions and learn more about this stuff.
Robot.
But he says this is like a top factory. It's like whatever any engineering has in respect to robots and stuff like this, you can come here and you can see what this is.
Robot, recimo not.
The one I have seen, the Kia, I don't know, was it in Czech Republic or Slovakia? I don't know. That was something. Wow. That I have seen, that really made an impression on me. That was like during MK Ultra when they brought me to that city, whatever it is. That was something really.
recimo noter namen človeka, ima tam ne vem koliko različnih pozicij
ja.
In sam jemlje se škatle ven zlaga, ko ne ja, mora ja, prijeti. Ja, ja, ja. Ko nam mora prijeti, malo poruka škatlo, ja. Da se malo,
Sela,
da se malo presortirajo.
Sela.
Tukaj tu fabriko no, sem še verjel, da šla okrog robota naredi. Jaz sem šel pa ven, sem pa že gruntal, če že roboti ljudje ne delajo. Tako,
tako naprej,
taka nevakalo. Automatika je not.
Pa je to, sem pa to reč, boste vedel, da v tej robotiki in v tej zadevah ni nič slovenskega noč, niti nič v vzhodne Evropi. To je pa stvar, katera se jaz bojim.
To so najbolj Kitajci. Od sande ta papeža, to je to...
Take a pen and write some more stuff. He mentioned about the robots. He said these Chinese are making these robots. He said probably they are Chinese, whatever. It's another issue he wants to remind me of. This is why he says from the Sandy Papesh, this was a good friend of mine, a really good friend of mine. We grew up as a kids together. His son was in China and the car was driving him alone around and this and that. Basically, it's like this. He also mentions Audi car. Okay. Yes, this is an Audi, I believe. I would say Audi that he had, Audi A4. Maybe even he got Audi A6, but always was a silver color. And he had these cars already. What I can remember, this silver color car they had, 100% is from 2008. But before that, I think he also had Audi. He had the beautiful car, the beautiful car. The beautiful car is Audi A6. And this was already since 2008, 100%. As a matter of fact, excuse me, I am now really talking stupid. Must be already since 2005, because this already, he had this car already. He was back and forth already when we were with Audi all the time, Audi. His son involved also in MK Ultra. I can tell you he's gonna mention that he became a candidate for, he wanted to become a president in Slovenia. Yeah. Shit, and he wanted to become a president of Slovenia when he was like 22 or something like this. This is what is the most striking to me. He's like, I don't know what he says, like a 30 years old or something like this. So you can say that I know something real about this family too. Now, if you would go and you would ask more about it, Sandy was involved in it, but because of the shit I started to steer, I have no idea what was about the Chinese. Basically anything, it doesn't matter even if I like it. Under MK Ultra, if I especially like Chinese, and if somebody wanted to tell me something that about the Chinese or whatever, then I would start to object. You know, I would just start to, just out of bullshit, start to object and tell whatever. Basically, fuck off. You know, I had a Chinese girlfriend, I like Chinese. Chinese alone knew this. Chinese were crazy about me. They advocated me. They advocated me, they liked me, and Eastern Europeans were trying to make the money out of it, and Americans were trying to make the money out of it. They were trying to, like, con Chinese. In reality, it was a Chinese that tried to calm down. It was a Chinese that made investment to Serbia because of me. In front of the Vucic, they stated, don't do nothing to this man, help him out, or there will be no investment to Serbia, literally like this. Chinese, top Chinese government. I didn't like to hear anybody tell me about Chinese. So I could turn any time in when I was drugged up or like this or like that or whatever. I didn't like this kind of stuff at all. I had a lot of reasons not to like it. Simple. And Sandy also liked Chinese. And he couldn't understand that I was against Chinese, and he went to China. First was the father, Sandy. Sandy was in China already sometimes in 2008. Then, like 4 years later, his son would also go something like this to China also. And then he would start to go more to China, if you want to know. So just write this down, all this stuff, because you heard it from me. No, I was not in any kind of agreement with the Sandy. I don't even know where he lives now and this and that. But if you would go and test me, and let's say this and that, probably that, I don't know, maybe if I would see his house or whatever, and his son and this and that and whatever went on, there would be a whole more that I would tell. Sandy was skipped. He kept contact with me. Many of these boys here did. They would not let go. Okay? So that's that. That much about Sandy Popish and his son. Thanks to this man.
Čas balkanski prvak kolesar,
seveda sem bil moj prijatelj.
No, sin,
ja.
Sin Žiga,
ja.
Je bil na japonskem,
ja.
Ali na kitajskem, se navedem, na kitajskem.
Ja.
Je, on ima krasen avto, zan sem videl Audija.
Ja.
Sandy Papež was a Balkan champion. He was a champion of Romania, Yugoslavia, all the countries, Hungary, all the countries in Balkan, Greece, all these countries, he was a champion. He won. His son, however, was in China. He was in, also in Japan and this and that. He's telling me he had the Audi, Krasny Audi automobile, Krasny Audi. Yeah, but the thing is that his dad was the first one. I remember with this man, this man would have me everywhere. This man would have me everywhere with this guy. We would walk to Brusnice, Gabri and so on, he would have me. And we oftentimes saw Sandy with a bicycle, with his son also, transporting car on his car on the roof. We saw, he always had an Audi. I remember it was Audi R4 also. He had like a dark blue Audi. I think it was Audi R4, if I don't remember that properly. And I'm pretty damn sure it was Audi. Man, he had this Audi like, what, 20 years it was Audi. And then sometimes, I think it was like in 2008 or something like this, but I'm pretty sure it was in 2006 or 2005, they bought this Audi also. It was probably Audi R6, like a silver color. Yep, so you can just keep writing down. Until mid-2006, I was not even here in Slovenia. No way somebody would have any kind of recording, any kind of proof in the world that somebody told me and this and that and tra-la-la-la-la or something. The stuff that I recorded, keep in mind, in 2008, I ran out of the Slovenia for life. And I did not return back to Slovenia almost until 2011. I was in U.S. in 2008, in 2009 in the U.S., and just before the new year, I came to Austria. I tried to file political asylum in Germany and in Belgium. I returned back to Austria, stayed there until the new year. For the new year, I took a ride, hike, literally, to Sweden, and from Gothenburg in Sweden to Oslo in Norway, where I attempted to file for political asylum and was literally assaulted over there by Norwegian immigration authorities. It was a panic when they saw me. It was like Donald Trump does, you know, that like this it was. Throwing my stuff out on the street. And eventually, in a process of it, used, unfortunately, you see, a Chinese Norwegian with a Chinese background who was quite abusive during MK Ultra. Oh, you see, there were things like this too, but you cannot say that this is a Chinese guy. This was just a Chinese who was in Norway, and as such, he served the purpose of Norwegian authorities, not Chinese authorities. And so you would get the dissidents from China that would engage in all kinds of bullying and bullshit and causing a problem here and there and, you know, all kinds of stuff that would create resentment in you. It's when I wrote on complaint to Norwegian authorities that I didn't come to Norway to actually file for political asylum with Chinese immigrant immigration officer. This is what Norwegian government did. Norwegian government had me inside of the Norway, inside of that particular Krogan Street, whatever that is, inside of that immigration office. The Chinese immigration officer knew me. The Chinese immigration officer in Norway knew me and have abused me psychologically prior to my filing for political asylum in Norway. So it was the stuff that you would not know anymore, you know, WATF. The guy who was immigration officer, however, was individual. I think his father, I think, was a Swedish, and the mother was from Finland, from Karlstad, where enormous MK Ultra went. He was the immigration officer in that immigration station where they threw me everything out on the street when I wanted to file for political asylum in 2010, involved in MKUltra. The whole Scandinavia, it was a whole nothing other than a setup. And in the Göteborg, in a Karlstad, later on, as I would go, from Bergen and so on, it was nothing else than terror. They had me inside of the mental hospital in Bergen in Norway and stuff like this. Now we can talk about all this stuff, what these people have done, how this stuff was. They cook this shit, this racism and all these things, and I can exactly point to you and explain to you how and why. I have more than a million reasons for this stuff. This is what they wanted from me. You understand?
Pa sem prašal, če še rab on voziti, ali greš sam. Je rekel, da ga mora še on voziti, ampak na Kitajskem. Si pa samo dal avto, si vse...
He said, in China, it's all automated. He said, when he came to China, he only would sit in the car and the car would take him to the place.
On je samo tipkal kodo, kam gre, brez šoferja. Sam avto ga pelje.
On je sam avto pelje.
We all know that this is what Elon Musk started. The Americans started this stuff, Germans started. Mercedes was the first one, actually, not Elon Musk. Germans started, Mercedes, Audi started all this stuff. I told him I don't like this kind of cars anyways. I don't like this kind of cars because this is, to me, the car that somebody, some kind of computer is going to operate my life. This will never happen. I will not give the right to the car to turn wheels for me instead. I tell him your Fiat 750 Fichko that you have inside of the garage, that one time you're going to sell it to me. I'm kidding, of course. I said, it's going to be, I'm not kidding. Before I'm going to sit in the car like this, definitely I will buy myself whatever kind of car that is not going to have that kind of stuff.
Jaz vam pa povem ena stvar, verjetno, da te avtomobili so super, ampak da po mene avto vozil sam okol, ki se pa ne bo sledilo. A to je nemski sistem, to so bili nemski vse to, da sem robil, da sem bo sam vozil amerikanski sistem, samo tudi tudi se malo, nekaj dnarja ni, da bo mene to. A tako, na Kitajskem pravite, da je Sandy Ford.
Ne Sandy, ta, sin je gov.
Sin je gov.
In kandidiral
tu. Pasta tvega, avto, pa je res. Pasta tvega.
opremo na zakonar.
Vas, no.
Jaz sem zmeraj jopis, on tak.
Ja.
In pa imam še kresničko, pa to, da se sem na steno.
Jaz sem pa rekel, da se sabo žem.
No, zdaj si jel mal, zdaj si jel mal za vlesko.
Bom jaz sem sabo.
Ne, jaz bom malo kremno, tle li sem, sem tle li
se. Ja, ja, jaz sem tukaj, da vas pospremim. Ker tam jaz sem se, jaz sem se nekam držav, ampak jaz sem tukaj, da vas pospremim.
Kam boš pa zdaj, ti tu naprej, kam?
Jaz sem nazaj, tukaj, do Moravče, da sem gledal, smo tam
početi
novo leto.
Aha.
Pa pa nazaj, nekaj. Vas sem tukaj za celo odložil.
Ne, ne, se ni problema, jaz ti sem
znamo. Ne, ne, kaj. Da smo že tu državno, pa tu jaz bom kar tukaj.
He says, and where are you going? I said, I am only gonna go here, and I am gonna to the family at Ratež. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna wish them a happy new year, and then I'll head back. But with you, I'm gonna go. I had a telephone with me, and I was using this telephone to alert drivers back and forth.
Jaz sem še tukaj, da se znam umikati avtomobilem. Čeprav jaz pa pravim tako, pešec mora biti na cesti viden in previden.
Seveda je.
To obo dvoje.
Seveda je.
Tudi če imaš zeleno luč na prehodu, poglej,
seveda
kaj
je.
Se dogaja, ker oni ne vidijo tega, pa kar gleda za avto.
Seveda je. Mislim. Nekog je pa star sino od sami.
Ja, pa ne
ali bilo, ali pa ne pa let, starejši.
Ne vem,
sam.
Oh, Sandy bil že 50.
Oh, Sandy bil že dan in 50. Tele v dolini pravite, da se da prije.
Ja, jaz bi tele, lep, lep pot.
Aha.
Lep pot.
To malo več je treba hoditi, pa smo še kaj srečali.
Ok.
Pa dole.
I also asked how old the son is from Pop, from Sandy Papish, and he said he would not know the answer. But I know the answer. He was like really, really young, like the youngest candidate ever who wanted to become a president. Like, it kind of shocked me, kind of threw me on my ass. But the thing about his son is that it's like he said, he's very, very communicative. He's a very, very nice person. He's a very nice person. He's just a person out there that is just, yeah, I'm sure he already has kids. He's a good catch, definitely, for one thing. For the ladies, they're like some kind of rabbit that would go out there that would be jumping all over the place and try to help people, whatever he can. Help people, so he would be like almost like I would say kind of a perfect person for this kind of candidacy. He is open to all the people, all the cultures, backgrounds, and so on. A very friendly person, and it was this is what I couldn't get about him. It was like I know that his father loved me, I know this, but I couldn't get because I could relate to him because he's about the same age like myself. Sandy is older about, I don't know, 2 years than myself, 3 years. And I was always supporting him. He was a biker. A biker, bike was the life to him. Man, this guy was just lived for a bike. We have few people like this from Novo Mesto, and they just became champions. And they would just concentrate on it, and they would not let it go. They would just collect medals, basically, and it opened life for them. And I just couldn't understand that his son, who was so young, like I was like, I was saying to myself, the fuck are you? I said, what? This, you're, I was looking at him, he was like 18, and I said to myself, and he was like a 22, and I said to myself, I said to Sandy, I said, come on, man, I was like embarrassed, under MK Ultra, really embarrassed. I said, come on, man, are you, this is my son. I said, yeah, it kind of looks like your son, dude. It's like young kid. And this was my impression. But once I started to talk to him, you know, the concern that would come out of him for me, he kind of feel the pain that I'm going through. It was a tremendous concern. It was just a tremendous concern that sometimes if you, and I'm also telling this to all of you people, that sometimes you might have the wrong opinion about the environment. Sometimes you have an opinion about environment that everybody is to himself and this and that. Sometimes you would be surprised that some people that you would never believe, like the guy the other day, like in part two, that you would have actually some people that would really, really care about you. And his son just happened to be also one of them. So don't think everything's so negative about the world. Yeah, right? I'm saying this to you. It's true. You would be surprised. Don't give up on life, ever. There are people out there who... This is lesson I learned from Sandy and from this kid the other day. That's why I said I would love to drive this car, this Renault 11 or what it was. It doesn't matter to me. It just really, really matters to me that, you know, I couldn't, as much as I would, and I wanted, I would do this. But I was so preoccupied with the situation in the U.S., how that stuff is going to resolve. Because of these warnings I got, that I would not, I did not even dare to think about doing something like this, that I would go and get that car and fix one and drive one. And guys suggested me to do this during MKUltra. It happened so. The only thing you would have to do, basically, he said, is do the registration and stuff like this. Is probably the car I would want to drive more than any other car, just as I was happy with the Felicia at the beginning. You know, with the Felicia, I didn't know that stuff is going to turn this way like that. It's mindless. But that car, I will tell this kid that lost his mom and dad, I would love that I drove your car more than any car I had. I would be more happy to drive that car than any other car I had. Unfortunately, the car now is finished. I saw the car, now the car really completely fall apart. But back then, if I only knew this, you know, if I would only dare to think about it, what I was told on an MKUltra, but I did not.
Je pa prva hiša, kar kaj, ja?
Pa vse spravi, če ti?
Avset.
Avset, ja, ja. Jaz ti pa so nekaj o povšetih govorim.
Ja, ja. A sem se več poznal povšet?
Povšet was a teacher, one of the teachers on this center I visited. The thing is that, in life, in real life, we never ever met. We never ever met with these people. This couple in real life, like that before this stuff, I left to US in 1995, in 1994 actually. The new year was a happy new year in Miami. And then it was a job on the ship overseas in Bahamas. Celebrity cruise line ship. Meridian was the name of the ship, which, by the way, they sink one. Yeah. Every trace, it would be like everything would started to dissipate around me. It's like all my past, it would like not exist. So did the ship, Celebrity, from Celebrity Cruise Line, Greek ship. What they did was they changed the name of the ship. They put the insurance on it, tremendous one, probably through this case. And the ship would just sink somewhere in a strait, if I tell you, if you want to investigate. Nobody drowned, though. Somewhere off Singapore, I think, strait, something like this. Where's the Singapore? The ship would disappear somewhere here along the Singapore. close to probably Johor, Singapore. Yeah, this is about the right location, Batu Pahat, right here that you see. So this is Indonesia. Yeah, made a long way from Bahamas. Yeah, folks, you are watching the real deal. You are not. This is not a fantasy. This is not imagination. This was a ship that had over 1,000 passengers on it. I don't know what happened. Go and read about it. Meridian was the name. Meridian Chandris was the owner. Greeks. Celebrity. Cruise line sold to whatever company. I'm going to make some other time when I have time. I'm going to play with that stuff. It's like stuff that you would not believe. It wasn't the 9/11 only. It wasn't those towers that fall apart around this case. It was other stuff that happened. This ship disappeared just about 2-3 years after I embarked over there in Miami. 2 years after I embarked in Miami. Things were happening. You can call them a coincidences. What is not coincidence in my life? Ask me about how I know the family I mentioned to you earlier, Moravets, and we know each other already for a very long time. I explain. I made a mistake had an idea because she was a teacher here in Gabaria, in Brusnica, a little place near this Ratež, toward mountains. She was a teacher there, that she was always, that she's from there and this and that. She's not, she's actually from the area, from Brežice, actually. And long, long, long time ago, I don't know how many, 50 years ago, whatever, she moved here to live with her hubby. They have fallen in love and they start life in Brusnica. And then they build a house over there in Ratež. She was a teacher, just like a husband. He teached math, physics, and she would teach language or something like that. Yeah, he says he was a great guy. I said, yeah, he was like a father, really. Terrible mistake I made when I say that she is local here from Brusnica. She has been here already for so long. And husband Rudy, he always joked about her. He always was about cherries from Brusnica, that they are tough, and Brusnica people from Brusnica, Gabria. It's kind of a funny stuff. Gabria, it's like a people, like from the mountain people, that they don't care about the weather and stuff like that, that she became hardened like this. It was just so much jokes that I forgot, really, that she was from Brežice, that she was from another location. It was already, and that was a mistake. I apologize for that. I made a mistake.
To je zdaj Klobučarjeva hiša, ta prva. Ta druga je Englava, tudi žive največ, ta tretja je pa Bravčeva. O, Marija, zdaj zbavim. Ne, da se tako pohjeta, no.
His son was, he was not a champion, but he did went, I think, one time to China when he was just like, I think the kid was like 12 years old or 13 years old, and he competed with the mat with the kids that were like globally, like on a global level, like Americans and British and Chinese and Russians and something like this, and he was very disappointed that he only got globally with the mat, or like, I don't know, the sixth place or something like this. It's not bad, hey, with the kids much older than he was, like 4 years older than he was. This isn't bad. This guy was like some kind of genius. He got the status of the genius, math genius. His father was the one who teach me a math. And this kid, he got a status of a genius from the Slovenian state. He got from the university, Jozef Stefan, like a special stipendium and stuff like this. He should have got far more than that. This stuff that went on with this, with Vladimir Putin and stuff like this, this is just completely nuts. Vladimir Putin got pissed off. A lawyer, supposedly he's a lawyer, that he's educated. He got pissed off at the neighbor here. At the neighbor. He promised, he, crazy Putin, start to think that he's gonna do something to him, that he is pretending to be smart, that he had an attitude and stuff like this, that he is brazen. Fucking Putin did not understand that this guy, and he was told that his brother had a mental deficiency, and the guy who got, he got, Putin got upset that he got 8 grades of grammar school is what he had. He worked in the local Ravos, in the factory, like a laborer, like he would do a labor work and stuff like this, and a little wrong smile. And this guy was the same height like a Putin. A little wrong smile, and the Putin assumed that he is effing with him, and he listened to him as good to go. Fucking guy Putin, eh? You didn't have to have any kind of political issues for this guy to whack you. Is what I'm trying to say to you. And he did whack him. It was back then when they realized it was more on a table than just the cancer pills. At the later stages, like I said, they had a different things. This neighbor, he got a problem with a breathing something. As if they would give something, but he smoked. They give him something to smoke. I don't know what they planted in a cigarette pocket. And for this stuff that I say right now, for this stuff I was actually told by all this family to please not say nothing. To please not say nothing. That was the time when the police told me that they are so dangerous, these things that are happening, this political stuff, that if you get to be killed immediately, it's a good thing. They told people the worst thing is because you would get the disease and you would suffer in pain. You would be dying slowly and you couldn't do nothing about it. They said, fuck, they said, this is the worst part about it. So please don't say anything. You don't know nothing about what goes on with this fucking Putin. It wasn't only two other neighbors that died. It was another neighbor here, like I said. And pay attention to the stuff I talk about.
Yeah. to, a ti si med narodno tekmovanje in to je bilo tako, da se to ono bilo.
Marija ima temo, ne vem ti doma.
Ja, če nisem. Voda ni nič, glavno je lepo. To se probo voci. Novo.
He says Maria has lights down, doesn't look anyone is at home. I said, it doesn't matter, then I'll just go home. But the important thing is that I wanted to wish them a happy new year. I was here. I really was. Maria, Katja, Primoš, I was there. And I would like to thank this man big time for this walk, because he opened a new horizon to me. The worst part that you're going to learn about Vladimir Putin is why the fuck he was doing this kind of stuff. Now, this is the shit that is going to rock you. If you are a Russian, you will learn why Putin was on a killing spree in Slovenia. What the fuck was it that got him make so many people disappear? They talked about the political stuff, that it was a political. No. There was something more than just political. There was something more. I'm going to explain to you all this as it comes. Who contributed to this stuff? What made Putin such a murderous machine? Literally.
Pa to, tale Sandi od Sandija, sin, kdaj bi potrebil pa enkrat v leta 2012, se pravi, nekaj ta azga je drugi.
Ne, 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 če je telo za predsednik, kar kaj zbira v mende, da
se. 2010, nekaj ta azga.
Ne vem.
Kako je pa sedmi
bol sin? Ne vem, le.
Ja, he tells me, I said, but this with the China, with this I already explained. Sandi went to China first. That was like 2008. Then he would go, I think, again, like 2010 something. He was interested in doing some kind of business. That now I said, but his son went already to China sometimes in 2012, if I properly remember. His son went to China 2013 for the first time, 2012. And then he would go again. So when this thing was with the cars, I'm trying to find out, probably, I don't know. Who knows? 2015 maybe, I don't know. He says, I ask about his age, he says, I don't know. Probably. Oh, he says one time he went also, he ran for the president. Yeah. When he was young, he did. And I was shocked because it was so easy to talk to him. He is very communicative, he says, yeah.
Žiga.
Mm-hmm. Evo, ti greš tle.
Hvala vam za
He says, you go here, and I thank him. He thanked me for the escort. I thank him very much for everything. I wish him a happy new year, all the best in new year, and basically we go apart. As I go apart, this is an edited tape. Of course, the original is at hand. This is the tape right here. It's about 2 hours and 3 minutes long. This is edited 27, 28 minutes, which I'm about to play you again as soon as I'm done doing this stuff. I always keep the original everything. At the end of this tape, maybe, I don't know, 20 minutes, something like this later, 30 minutes, as soon as I disappear between the houses, I record. And I also tell the girl moved to Miami. Yeah. As far as earlier, the girl returned back from Miami. You know when? She returned to Miami probably it was some kind of a Slovenian guy that she met over there. I remember this. It was some kind of a Slovenian guy. It was some kind of Slovenian guy that she met, she lived with in Miami. She would return back, but we wouldn't see much. Sometimes in, I believe, what was already 2012, I think, something like this it was, that's about 8 years. So, yeah, she did return back, there you have it. I'm not surprised that she wouldn't see me after experiencing this kind of stuff. This is a difficult, this is trauma. It makes you think twice whether you want to see this, you know, be around a person like this. In a certain way, this is difficult. I want to thank everybody, and you can hear me saying, the people involved in MKUltra, the girl, not Fort Myers, not St. Petersburg, Miami, North Miami, indeed. I did state it that I definitely did. It doesn't matter whether I did or not. I already tell you right now. The only thing I'll do is I'll go ahead. It's very difficult to understand because I walk. I'll just go ahead and I'll play the whole tape again. That's all. Thanks for watching this video. Till next time.
Dobar dan. Mam neki skor, što mam.
Grabim zdrs na noć.
Ja nas svi sam imao duo.
Ja, ampak sam se ujel, već da je na taj zdrs. Jesu
ću
u prek stopu.
Mate telefon, sabo?
Nemam.
Jesu ko s moj mami govorim, telefon, sabo.
Ja.
Se mi gubu po stopu.
Vejo pod grijem, če me na odamu da se iskrati.
Telefon.
Leta ne gori avto, kurba, kako se ga prilekli v fotka. Okulja bar in še klije sama gor.
Ja, nekako je prišlo. Nekako je prišlo, reka.
Morda, da si še sam pripeljal, veš?
Kje ste pa vi?
Zrakežlo.
Zrakežlo ste, ne?
Aha, ti pa?
Jaz sem avšel Boštjan, iz Krke.
Aha.
Ja. Ta avto.
Je že dolg sem ve?
Ta avto je že kar nekaj cajta.
A res, je že dolg nisem te pojde.
Ta avto je že kar nekaj cajta tam, ki mi je barka sosega tam. Od enega mladega fanta, mehanika.
Od unga pa je že bračike?
Vrta Čiča je bil.
Vrta Čiči? Kuralč. Je bil klepar, ne bil mehanik.
Umrla samo oče in mama.
In on je umrl že.
Je pa ne bo držal, on je umrl. On je 20 let.
20 let pa mehanik.
Je.
No sem od znasa.
On je imel, nekdo mu je pomagal, ko je mama pa oče, ko so badva umrla. Mu je tele iz Novega mesta. Pa nisem pa zvičan, da je to celo en policist, da mu je pomagal. Mislim, da je bil policist, pa nisem prepričan. Je bil pa en tak gospod, starejši tukaj ste bil v takih letih. In mu je dolgo stanovanje tele na Majde Širca, na Ragovski. Na Rajovski mu je dolgo eno stanovanje in neki cajt je bil v njegovom stanovanju. Ne vem, ti je bil še, da je še takrat še v šolo hodil, da se ni iz Rateža skozi do Novega mesta, gor pa dol. Pa delati že začel takrat v tisti delavnici tam pri Merkurju.
Ja?
Ja. Vidijo, je li ti je temo?
Ga iščem. Eden je veliko v zaporih, tu je en...
V zaporih?
Prav te si pisal. Starša moj pa eden tudi z našega si ustrelil in počel sebe.
Tu ne more dotreti.
Ta je brez polmehanik.
Oče je naredil samo more njega. Obtežijo se ga nekih stvari in je bilo tako težko, da je samo more naredil.
Ja.
Mama je pa bolehala z eno boleznjo in ona je bila potem ta zadnja.
Lej, ne moram ga najti.
Se ne spomnil, ne štega.
Ne, to je bil vratežen.
Je v zapori, ste rekel, kdo je v zapori?
Ta je več zaprt, ta fant, ko je starše in pol še postrelil.
starše mi je postrelil nekdo?
Ja, eden, ki nekaj sta... Nekaj sta handlala, pa je ta tramtek, kakor on ga nekaj okul prinesel. Iz to isto pištolo, ko mu je on jo prodal, ne vem kako draži, kakor je dobil, je ta ustrelil njega in njegovo ženo in pa še sebe na Ratežu.
Kako se je pisao ta gospod?
Tramte.
Tramte?
Po vseh je pa postrelil.
Po vseh je pa postrelil?
Ja.
Ampak ta gospod Tramte je bil mehanik?
Ne, on je bil pri gasilcih.
Pri gasilcih je bil v službi?
Ta star, ja. Fant pa ne vem, kje je, če sploh kje je bil. V glavnem on kakšne pizdarije velik dela. Tudi v kamulom pa tako, pa veliko arestov.
V ječi je bil velik časa. Po vse se piše.
Ne, ta se Tramte piše.
Tramte. Se pravi, sin je preživo?
Sin je preživo, ja, pa še dve ščirke sta.
Pa dve ščirke sta?
Ja, ena ima enega Benetika, je tudi na Ratežu tam hišo.
Benetika?
Benetika, Marjana,
Benedik.
Ja.
Ja, ampak pa... tu so se pa tu že zdavnej delač nazaj,
ja,
ko so se poročila.
Ja,
tu
je zgarih in postrelosti.
Čakaj, tu se je zgodilo kdaj, pred 20 leti.
Recimo, ja, ne.
Tu se spomnim jaz. Samo mene tukaj ni bilo uradno.
Ja, verjamem.
Uradno me ni bilo.
Aha, ampak po pričevanju drugih.
Amerikanci so mu pripeljali tukaj, ja, iz Amerike. Vse veste, kaj je bilo tukaj.
Ja, Amerikanci...
Politika, kaj je bilo tukaj, kaj se je dogajalo. Tako da, to se pa spomnim. Tu se pa spomnim. Pa sta še skupaj.
Sestra od tega, ki je bil streljen,
ja.
Tramteta je pa tudi v Ameriki bila. In je tam zraven hišo nabila.
Sestra od Tramteta.
Od Tramteta, ja.
Je tudi v Ameriki, ja, bila. Sestra od njega.
Njega, starejša.
Se pravi, tu imaš eno sestro in ona je bila v Ameriki.
Ja.
Pa najmanj da v Miami, ok. Meni se zdi, kaj je bilo tisto Fort Myers, St. Petersburg. To je na drugi strani Miamija. Na drugi strani Florida.
Ne vem, kaj ne poznam isto Ameriko tako podrobno, veš. Čako si pa že ona pisala, je imela slovenski princ?
Vse se spomnim na to vse. In tu je bilo tudi... Tu je bilo tudi zelo delač nazaj.
Ja, se je vse.
Tu je bilo tudi, ne vem, kdaj je bilo tudi, 2002...
Zdaj ni novega več
je bilo tudi, kdaj je takrat, 2002, ki je ta
asla. Verjetno, ker cajt gre hitro naprej.
Čakaj, pravite, da zdaj ni nikoli gre več juga?
V tej hiški, ko je bila tako, je za Ameriko poslala, so čist drugi ljudje.
Mega sred.
Ja, ja. Čist. Kdo bi bil pa na Ratežu, še da bi mehanik bil, pa da mi oče samomor naredil?
Oče pa samomor naredil. Da se ga obtožil, se ga... In...
Ne, se mora biti res, sem da ne klikne ta moment.
Jaaaaj.
In kako naj bi ta fant bil zdaj star, ko pravi, da je ta
auto pripravljalo? Star je pa tam zakoč 20 let.
Zdaj le 20 let?
Ja, mlad je se.
S tem avtoprevoznikom se ukvarja tudi Kovačič Klemen. Transport Klemen ima napisano na kamionih. Sam to ni mehanično.
On dela v delavnici, kar je v Merkurju.
To sem v drugi srečala vožu.
Te pa groza, super pa sišim, pa te pa, tu me pa zvije, totalno.
Nimaš
kaj. Še spomnim, ko teh zadev, tu je še kuč.
Ja, prišel je zjutraj ta možakar ima žago doma, si še zdaj. Za hlode žagat, za te dele, pa je prišel na žago in pa vše površine pa v dolin, za potokem, gor. Prv njega ustrelil, pa je žena vam priletela še
vnosti. Ja, da je to tako noro rata, da se ja. Pa to si
pa... Ja, se slišal zdaj nekaj,
da spet. Sam, če sem jo vse povedal.
35 let mora... staro partner, ko bo pa njene starše, da je nekaj poklav zdaj. Jo, kam boš ti zdaj krenil?
Ja, zdaj malo sprohode se pa ne gor pa
dal. Ja, zdaj vem, kjer bom krok naredil. Ma kurva, tako je drslo postrelo.
Kje pa gre se videl rata za nazaj?
Ja, jaz bom šel zdaj le. Tle gor včas grem tlele za hostel, pa grem za znasom noter v tisti jark, pa gor pa po hostel.
Pa grem z vami, lahko gremo skupaj.
Ja, lahko.
Jaz sem se tako zdravil, da sem nekaj, ko sem na Ratežu.
Jaz grem tlele, bom si tle, da bom šel tisto jamo.
Hoče ti sveto novo leto.
Hvala enako.
Pa sem Jaz sem tudi bostem vam srečo novo leto.
Neč, hvala enako.
Hvala sem je tudi čez, pa mi ni nekako odštelo. Je plaka tam gor.
Tako, jaz moram se prvi toliko.
Ampak to, ni, to ne gre po cesti, ne? Ne gre to po cesti.
Bomo šlati skupaj tudi po cesti.
Po cesti greste?
Ačaj.
Pa ni tam tisti avtomobili, drvijo, norijo gor, pa dol
ja, tisti kurva, bom, bom, bom. Dol v jam je pa hudo, veš.
V jam je pa zale voda, ne da?
Ja, se bojim, bi preveč blata.
Se pravi, to je samo po cest.
Po ne, ne, ne. Bomo šla do Gumbrka, do prve hiše, bomo šla po hod zdaj.
Ja.
Bom šest pa po cest.
Ja. Pa ni bolj šele jeti čez, če se to, če se pa gor šele, ki se gre na rad.
Ja, ne, jaz grem tlej, če mi ne to sem. Ne, se greš ti lahko ono pot svoje, ki smo se jeti.
Ma jaz sem z vami, tam bomo, prej na skupaj, prej na skupaj. A, jaz se tu nič ne citiram za to, ki se meni tole, lejte. Tukaj, ki grem jaz, ki se mi v serije tole, to jaz tako naredim, da čevle, tjela čevle, to vam priporočam, da si kupi. Stane tam, ti smo dekatlonu v Ljubljan, 11 evrov, to samo. Zdaj, samo številko svoje je treba vedeti, pa se jih prek interneta naroči.
Jaz tu te sopate, pa tu fino hodim, tu ljubim.
Vse so take dobre zglede.
Pa. Samo za poljuža smene.
Tole bom rekel takole. Nič nisem motorni. No. Pa sem kar nekaj prehodil, da nas podlačim. Druga stvar je pa ta, da jaz jih ne pustim nič. Jaz, ko poblatko vodim z njimi, se zato sem naročil še ene za mesto. Ko poblatko vodim z njimi, pustim tako, ker je. Zdaj, tega, ker enkrat so se počet tu, ko sem videl, se ti nekaj tačkom ne pustajo. Podplati sem v stranu, hvala, ki jo se krije. Tako da tisto lepilo, ki je tisto najbolj tudi tako, ker je bilo originalno. Pa pa enkrat, ko blata ne bo, tako ti bom pa spucal fino, spucu se mi. Ampak tudi tako spucam, da samo s prsti, ne s krtača. Tih ne krtača.
Jaz sem se
zrušno
odstranil in verjel tehnikov,
ne na strokovno spodijo. Ja. Na če
je
spucal? Ja. Ja, seveda, zaradi tega, da ti ne varnosti, ne? Da ti ne pade karkoli, da ne bi bilo kaj.
In se mu skevli, ki se bi mogli kaj stare, ti snove, ne?
Ja,
ja. Sreto varni, ja. Varno sem poplačil zubo.
Kako pravite?
In sreto pa brinke sem poplačil zubo.
Od plate ste zgubo v sred fabrike?
Fabrike na te.
Na Češkem.
Zorba,
zato si narodim. Zdaj, kaj hlupo vam, da se mi ste izbil, ki je, ki je take čevle, mislim, ki je pa res.
Mislim, sem da nekaj imam, pa sem nekaj.
Ja, ja, ja. Pa se vi tudi imate tako po Češkem šel, pa tako. In te bo zato enega tam 2003, ali kaj ta zda.
Ja, pa to bolj. Ne, to je zda, to znaj.
Pa tudi takrat ste bil. Jaz
sem od 2005
bil v 2005?
Ja.
Ja.
Ampak sem šla še dvere in sedaj podmeti.
Ampak ste bil, ne, takrat?
Jo.
Kaj je bil, 2003?
Ja, pa pa vem, rečem.
Aha. Aha.
Kul, super, tam bili so kultrene vode, ne?
To je najlepša reka na svetu, ker jih je. Jaz lepši od kar jih reči nisem. Pa sem bil po to po svetu.
Taka mirna, ne?
Včasih je mirna, včasih pa ni. Tukaj jih paše vreme. Tukaj jih paše vreme. Je pa tu lepotica. Poved se da plavati kilometre in kilometre po nej. Pa tudi po zimšele noč toči. Tudi po zim sem malo plavil, no.
Res?
Ja.
Rance nekaj gledal do poznanskih.
Pa se vede.
Ja, ne premen delal v revozu.
V revozu? Ja?
Jo. Balbin Mohar je bil tudi tam nekaj, ne?
Aha. Ja, ja, seveda.
Balbin pa ne vem, kje je.
Vas Krka.
Kaj?
Vas Krka.
Ja.
Ja. A, kako je pa tu?
Pa Boris tam Mohar je bil pa. A, te Jožne, če je bil Mohar, to ne?
Mislite me, da od Majde?
Od Borisa Mohar, da ne poznam te, fantastika.
Ja, jaz tudi, bom rekel, nisem z njimi v kontaktu, tam v vasi tudi. Vem pa veliko o soferi. In tudi na žalost, da nisem tudi v kontaktu. In tudi upam, da v prihodnosti, da bom bil več z njimi v kontaktu. Moram tukaj
si gasiško društvo, ki se pa bo smo pol možnost
poznali. Na sesko drosto bi se opisal.
To vznar festa okoli ne delaš?
Ja, pa to lahko, to mi ni tako. To bi, za celo. Jaz se bojim, da nalje je drugi spod, da preveč bi je. To se bojim. Mi je spod tukaj govorili na njih. Maja za take stvari.
Sem malo, enega maja preveč.
Enega maja tujk, da spod, da skoraj da je ta dna. Da ta dna več zana bi se dobro.
Če bi bil razdeljen,
to je po en sam.
Med vse ljudi, ves.
Ja, dobro, da imaš nekaj hvala, ki pojene, je v redu. Se pravi, 2500 v penzionu lepo. 2007. Živci? Kako živci? Ja, no. Okay, tako fizično, okej.
Kaj, to je tudi,
ne?
Tudi obrata.
Ja.
Evo smo 7 dni v tednu, 24 ur na dan.
7 dni na tednu?
Ja, tako
da. Ja, ja, ja. In tu se je garalo noč, ko psi se garalo noč.
In seveda, tla je osnovna delovna nota, katera je Franco Kubeta iz ene šef.
Ja.
Bistov iz menovodje, bistov vodje odelkov.
Ja.
Jaz sem bil pa edini, ne?
Ja.
In ni bilo važno, če bilo problem, v pol način me poklica, sedaj put. Pa nisem čutil, da je to neko obremenitev, veš?
In to vas je pa zjebalo, mislite, da je to bilo? Mislite, da je to bilo?
Ja, lej, ne vem. Drugega ne nisem nič stadil, doma
sem. Jaz sem takih stvari počel, nori takih ne bomo to delo. In tako naprej. Pa je pa to vas fizično, ki je bilo, ali je bilo samo tako psihično?
Ja, lej, nič ne apetita za jest, ne volje do dela, ležal, bolj si jutro.
Pa to pa je. Pa se bil, pa se mu tist efekt, v bistvu. Ker takrat, ki so upokojili ljudje,
ne, ali nisem poslušil. Meni je še manjkalo dve leti do penzione, sem bil pol od 2005 do 2007 na čakanju. Počne še
vrnimo.
Ne bi ta tak prememba izdela.
A pa že zdaj se pa bolj počutil, ne?
Zdaj sem počutil. Zdaj vedno, kad ne jedo, imam preveč kin.
Zdaj tu pa, tu si pa zlato. Jaz jih pom tudi preveč.
Jaz sem te imaš srečo, ki bi zdaj.
To smo se tudi, ja. Jaz to pravim, za vsega, ki je več od mene, pravim, kot imamo srečo, ki sem več od mene.
Ja, ta formula je povezana z višino in če višina menjna, kile velike pa so kurde.
Red jesta, ne?
Vprašaš. Žena dobro kuha.
To je to, si to pravim. Ja, žena dobro kuha in je to, ne? In tu je, tu sem bil tam. Na Češko ti je bila ena velikanska tovarna, kaj je bilo, v Škoda ali kaj je bilo?
Jo.
V Škodino, v Škodino. Pa kako primerjaviti vse, da se vozim od tega?
Ja, revoz je špica.
Špica je, ne? Boljši je od Škode, boljši ima.
Urejeno je sigurno.
Urejeno ima boljši. mega sveti.
Zdaj ti pa ne rečem ta Bahčeva, lej sem tukaj tukaj gor prišel. Lej, pot, tukaj sem gor prišel.
Se pravi, vi ste pa...
Kaj?
Vi ste pa to vse videli na svoje oči, ste pa lepo ocenil, ko ga se v Nemci dal, dejansko, da je bilo. In ste ocenil, da to ni to, ker v bistvu...
Čeprav,
ma, recimo Renault,
taro, čeprav ti avtomobili, glede na ceno,
ja,
ki jih Škoda dela, niso slabi, veš?
To so dobri avtomobili,
ja, so
ampak...
Avtomobili.
Ampak...
Kaj?
Investicije same, to...
Mislim, so... sama tovarna, red pa
ja,
tu je v revozu. Da ti pa narečem, jaz grem s tem društvom strojnih inženirjev in tehnikov, vse sorte pogledat gremo.
Aha.
In ti moram reči, da ta tovarna v veliki lok, ko jo ima bašt, ki dela te razne podsklope, za najboljše avtomobile v Evropi,
ja,
ne rabiš po Evropi hoditi gledat, le pa jih pogledat.
Kako je narejeno?
Robot, recimo noter namen človeka, ima tam ne vem koliko različnih pozicij,
ja,
in sam jemlje se škatle ven, zlaga, ko
ja,
nam mora
ja,
prijeti.
Ja, ja, ja.
Ko nam mora prijeti, malo poruka, škatlo,
ja,
da se malo,
kaj tjela,
da da se malo presortirajo.
Presortira.
Ja. To sem šel v fabriko, no, sem še verjel, da šlo okrog robota naredi. Ko sem šel pa ven, sem pa že gruntal, če že roboti zdi me delajo, tako. Taka...
Tako naprej, ne?
Taka avtomatika je noti.
Pa je to, sem pa to reči, boste vedeli, da v tej robotiki in v teh zadevah ni nič slovenskega, noč nekaj nič v vzhodne Evropi. To je pa stvar, katera se jaz bojim.
To so najbolj Kitajci. Od Sande ta papeža, to je tudi ten fan z Rateža, ki je bil čas balkanski prvak, kolesar.
Seveda sem bil moj prijatelj.
No, sin,
ja,
sin Žiga,
ja,
je bil na japonskem,
ja,
ali na kitajskem, še na kitajskem.
Ja.
Je, on ima krasen avto, zanj sem videl Audija,
ja,
pa sem prašal, če še rab on voziti, ali greš sam. Je rekel, da ga mora še on voziti, ampak na kitajskem. Si pa samo dal avto, si vse vnoti, samo tipkov kodo, kam gre, brez šoferja.
Ja.
Sam avto ga pelje.
Pa gre sam avto
pelje.
Samo je pa zdaj pa stvar tako, da meni se pa jebe za tako automobil. Ni se vsak avto vsedu pa nepno.
Ja, vidiš nepno.
Tako da, tist pičko, ki ga imate v garaž, tist ga boste enkrat sven prdel. Jaz vam pa povem ena stvar. Verjetno, da te avtomobili so super, ampak da po mene... Avto. Vlažil sam v polj,
ali
se pa ne bo sredilo. A to je nemski sistem, to so nemci vse to tako naredili, da te bo sam vozil amerikanski sistem. Ne? To, samo tudi sem malo. Nega denarja ni, da bo mene to vse usmuralo samo. A tako, na kitajskem pravi, da ni sam bil polj.
Ne Sandi, ta, sin je gov.
Sin je gov.
I kandidiram
tu. Pašte gleda, auto, ja, aha, je res. Pašte, prosim.
Ne smo opremljeni, da se ima.
Paš, ma.
Da smo zmeraj jopi, on tak.
Ja.
In pa imam še kresničko, pa to,
ja,
da se na steno.
Ja, tu sem pa rekel, da ti sabo
je. No, zdaj si je malo. Zdaj si malo zavljeno.
Jaz sem sabo.
Ne, jaz bom malo kremno, tudi sem tudi še.
Ja, ja, jaz sem tudi, da vas posprejel. Ker tam jaz sem se nekam držal, ampak jaz sem tudi, da vas posprejel.
E kam boš pa zdaj, ti šel naprej? Tam.
Jaz sem nazaj, tudi, do Moravče, da sem gledat malo.
Aha. Počet
in novo leto.
Aha.
Pozdrav pa nazaj. Na krpa. Vas sem mu tudi zatele odrozimo.
Ne, ne, se ni problema, jaz ti sem
znam. Ne, ne, kar. Da smo že tako državno, pa tudi bom kar skoraj držal.
Jaz sem še to, da se znam umikati avtomobilem. Čeprav jaz pa pravim tako. Pešec mora biti na cesti viden in previden.
Seveda je.
To obo dvoje.
Seveda je.
To, če imaš zeleno luč na prehodu, poglej,
seveda
kaj
je,
se dogaja. Kaj oni ne vidijo tega, pa kar gleda za avto.
Seveda je. Sestrini. Nekog je pa star sin od sami.
Ja, pa ne
on je bil, ali pa ni par let starejši.
Ne vem, to je
skrpno.
O, Sandi je bil že 50.
O, Sandi je bil dan je 50. tele v dolini. Pravite, da se ga prideš.
Ja, jaz sem tele, lej tle pot.
Aha.
Tle pot.
To malo več je treba hoditi, pa smo še kaj srečali.
Upen.
Pa dol. Tam se bo to tako, kaj ga hoče v glasno na Krki. Je pa prva hiša Krka, ja.
Pa vse spravi se
kaj? Auset.
Auset, ja, ja. Jaz, pa, jaz ti pa so nekaj o povšetih govorim.
Ja, ja. A se se veš poznal povšet? Pod... ja, drug.
Ne bi različen, ta žena je nekje iz drugega konca doma. Z moste celi tjel, od Brežic.
Ja, se je reja.
Tle, učila je pa tle?
Učila je pa tle.
Aha. To je zdaj Klobočarjeva hiša, ta prva. Ta druga je Engljava, tudi žive največ, ta prijatelj pa. Vravčeva. O, Marije, pa izbavim. Ne bi se tako pohjetljeno. Prijmo še tudi neki stručk v matematiki.
O, on je bil pa... je že bil domenjen. Je še na tekmovanja. Je tako naprej. Posod, mednarodno tekmovanje. Zdaj, tako naprej.
Marija Matemo, ne vem ti doma.
Ja, če nisem. Voda ni neč, glavno je, da sem. Da se probo voči. Novo leto, če smo vse pa. Pa tu, tale je Sandi, od Sandi, a sin. Pa daj bi pa tu bilo pa enkrat v leta 2012, se pravi, da neki ta azga je ljudi.
Ne, enkrat je celo za predsednika, kaj ti
gledamo in deli. 2010, neki ta azga. Ne vem. Kako je pa sad ne bol sin?
Ti ne vem, lej. Ne vem. Je pa tak, zelo komunikativno, veš?
Se lahko... Kdo? Sandi?
Žiga.
Žiga. Žiga mu je ime.
Uh-huh. Evo, ti greš tle. Hvala za...
Hvala vam. Hvala vam za vse.
Lahko mi si zelo. Ajde, lahko noč.
Ja, sem malo. Ja, sem malo.